Boom, 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 boom.
I lay down, think why you don't treat me kind sometimes. I lay down, thinking why you won't treat me kind sometimes. Yes, I'm gonna tell you the reason why you got other things on your mind. I'm gonna do. Yeah, now can't a woman act funny when she got another man? You know she won't look straight at you, boy, she's always raising sand. Can't woman act funny, she got another man. You know she won't look straight at you partner, then she's always raising sand. I hope you do all right. Faze the day, cause I'm coming to see you tomorrow night. Good violin angel, darling, I hope you feel right. You know I'm going away to leave you, but I'll see you tomorrow night.
Light this mountain down on parts my father. Just give me life this morning down on parts my father. I wouldn't hate it so bad, but I left my wife and mom. By wife, all you have done gone. Oh, goodbye, wife, all you have done gone. But I hope someday you will hear my lonesome song. Man, I don't mean no harm. Oh, listen, you man, I don't mean no harm. If you wanna do good, you better stay for touch my phone. We go to wake in the morning just to dawn of day. We go to wake in the morning sister, dawn of day. The city said no, the sun dies. Window, wake your dawn. I'm down on old Parchment's phone. I sure wanna go back home. I'm down on old Parchment's phone, but I sure wanna go back home. But I hope someday I will overcome.
Hello and good morning, actually. Here, yeah, I was going to say good evening, but I'm up early. How's everyone going? Good morning, good evening, good day, good night. It's good, not good night, not that one. How's it going? We're going to check out some indie games from the modern era. Just checking my tablet there, that's nothing. And yeah, we're going to check out some Software Inc. And because I haven't played that for a while, it's still actually in early access. And we're going to check out Noita, which is pretty much done now, I think. It used to be getting an update every few days, now I think it's done. So we'll probably get our ass kicked in that, but we'll start with something a bit more relaxed, like Software Inc. I don't know how much it's changed, so I'm going to go through the tutorial, and I guess we'll start with that and go from there. Probably for a couple of hours, then some Noita for until it gets too frustrating. And then maybe something else, if people have suggestions or whatnot. You can even check out my Steam profile to see what games I have there. But yeah, let's get into the game. Hopefully I've already balanced the audio a little bit, but it might still need a little bit of adjusting. Alrighty. And hopefully this will just work, because I haven't actually tested this, so I'll go full screen. Yeah. Looking good. Now, how's it sounding? Well, I can only sort of hear how loud it sounds at my end. Just let me know if it's too loud or whatever. It's not really a noisy game. Do I need to change anything just since we're streaming? Solution's fine. That should be okay. Do we have mods on? No? Or do we? Don't think so. Buildings. Stored locally. Oh, these will be fine. They're just like optional things. Not really game-changing things. Espresso? Is that an espresso machine? Nice. People like that. Unless they're too noisy. Noise is a factor in this game. Error mods. Does that mean there's a problem with these mods? They're probably too old, if anything. What's the error, though? Who wants to tell me? I don't know. Mods from Steam should update themselves, but we're not really going to be focusing on mods. We're going to start a new game, and we're probably going to have to like restart by renting someone's small, shitty garage and, you know, go from there. But that's, I guess, how people start in the software industry. Alright. If anyone's got any ideas for a business, then that's cool, we can have a look. Or else I'll probably just call it something like War Incorporated or something like that, I don't know. But first we've got to make our person and decide on some specialties and some looks, of course. So, we'll see what the tutorial says about everything. I pretty much know the basics. I mean, I played this at least a year ago, maybe. Customization screen, press continue to advance tutorial. Okay, continue. Begin by picking a name for your company. Let's just start. Oh, I'll put in at least a temporary one, and if no one else has suggestions, it'll be the permanent one. Forsoft, because we're going to be a software company. I mean, that's a fine name if no one else has any issues with that. Well, you better not have any issues with it, but suggestions could work. Name. Anonymous is the default name. I might just go with Fornado. Guess we'll make it a male character, sort of based on me. Can we randomise the looks? Because I don't know if I can be bothered going through every like kind of like a sim style character creation. There should be a way. I thought there was. Yeah, jaw height, jaw width, ear size. There's a lot of little options here. Eyebrows thickness. Wants some thick eyebrows. That's a sign of a good programmer. Does it need to be more curvy though? Yeah, he looks more inquisitive like that, like he's focused, kind of. Yeah. There's not many options, is there? It's pretty much my hair there, isn't it? Can I rotate him? Okay, is there a colour? Does it have to be... white? Surely it doesn't. It's sort of like my hair, except mine's not quite that neat at the back, really, you know? Or probably at the front, even. Where's the colour? Why is it that colour? Colours, okay. Hair. We got my hair colour, or have we over exaggerated a bit? Okay, that's pretty much it there. Oh, you know, skin coloured hair. Oh. Right, yeah, okay. Are that my ears? I don't know. Head. Hair size. Ooh. Hair position. What can you make them move forward a bit? Nose width. I suppose for being realistic, that's going to be out of it. But yes, these are tiny things that you're not even really going to notice. Face. Full beard. Yeah, I mean, we're a programmer. You got to have a full beard. Have you ever seen a programmer? In the flesh? Sometimes you can't see the flesh because there's so much beard. Okay, I don't know why that defaults to white, but go with nice, kind of darkish. Yes. Look at that. We've got a cat, apparently. I don't know if that's actually part of the game now. It'll be interesting. Hopefully it looks after itself. Torso, blouse, t-shirt, shirt, hoodie, suit. I'm not really a suit kind of person. I mean, I don't usually wear shirts, but I could do if I was running a business. Hoodie's kind of your typical chillaxed programmer. The blouse. I like the hoodie. I don't know why everything has to be white by default, but we can change that. Pantaloons. We can have pants, trousers, shorts, cargo shorts. What have we got? Pants. Trousers. Oh, yeah, casual. Shorts. It's getting to summer. Or cargo shorts. That's not bad. That's probably more like something I might wear. What about green? I mean, if I had green ones, I'd probably wear them. Accessories. Glasses. Sunglasses. No glasses. Glasses? Okay, no. Oh, I guess we'll go no glasses. I don't wear glasses. Not yet. One day. Colours. Skin colours. Really accurate. Be a bit pastier. Eyebrows fine, beard's fine. Torso is... I don't know. I can wear a twitch purple. Or a deep blue. Hey, 13 cosplay, how you going? Welcome in. What's new? We're just starting. And making a guy, and then making a software company. Blue is nice. Why not? Oh, there's too many nice colours. Why aren't there only like three nice colours? Then it'll be easy to pick. Yeah, that's something like that. Doing well, working from home right now, while Freya naps off on some drugs. Well, what's she been on? Catnip? Or like, what do you call it? Vet drugs? Have you been? I've been pretty good. I haven't been streaming for about a week, but I've been watching other streams and sorting out some other things behind the scenes for this stream and other streams. Yeah. Well, there's not really much to sort out on my stream. I just kind of decide to stream and then I start doing it. Quite informal. Pants colour. I don't know. A cargo-y short colour that... khaki? Yeah, I should try and catch some more of your streams. I don't think I've seen you for a week or two, have I? What were you last playing? Started something new? No, I can't remember now. Oh yeah, I saw you playing Nier. Are you still playing Nier? Or Automata or whatever? That was cool. Colours, why does this doesn't even really matter? Pick a colour. Nice, earthy tones. Okay. Begin by picking a name, pick a company, oh, we've done that. Pick a name for the founder, yeah, we've done that. And a gender, done that. Customization, we've done that. And, oh yeah, I gotta pick some skills or personality traits. generous, optimistic, oh, I don't know. Flirt, I don't know if that's a good trait in a boss, being a flirt. Stubborn, goofy, introvert. Fast learner, but not a hard worker. Hmm. Been extra busy with work. Oh, okay. Since we lost our AP. Alright. Was that like assistant something rather? So I've had several nights of no stream. Ah. Oh, that would explain why I haven't seen you, I guess. Glad I'm doing well. Yeah, pretty well. Stubborn? I'm not really stubborn. Although I'm not necessarily trying to create me exactly. Dramatic. Why not? Dramatic. Independent, social, lazy, stressed. Okay. Dramatic and... I don't know. Optimistic. Why not? Social was good. It means he works better with the team, I guess. Lazy, stressed. He's somewhere in the middle. That's not too bad. You don't really want to be too much of either, I guess. Lazy or stressed. Okay. And you can pick his finest skill, so I might make him specialise in at least one area, so he's not just like a jack of all trades. Although, initially, he probably will be the main person. You know, without anyone else there. Yeah, do you know when you can next stream? Or does it just depend when you're less busy? And what's working from home like? I guess that's okay. You hear the cats around. You could just stream working. Been playing some Nier though. Sterling gave me his old PC. Oh, I'm wicked. Been playing some Horizon Zero Dawn and Destiny 2. Also, it's like more powerful than your laptop. But I can handle those games no problem. I need to see if I can get some of the retro games going again. Yes, definitely. I mean, that's something that I do quite a lot. So if you need help getting old games working, then hit me up. Because I know a few tricks. Or at least a few programs that do all the tricks themselves. Right. This guy, lead. Is that like his ability to be a leader? Okay. I guess he should be a good leader? I don't know. Programmer, designer, artist. Service? What's that? That's new. That used to be something else. Increases the effectiveness of human-facing tasks, such as support, marketing. Oh, okay, they just put all the like, marketing and support into one thing. He could be good at that. Look, we've apparently got a cat, a programmer cat. Enjoy working from home, you can pet for her all day, yeah, fair enough. I could pet Bernard all day, but he doesn't really hang around. In fact, he's been out hanging out with the chicken a lot. They're like best friends now, I think. Right, programmer lead. Service. I could be a good programmer. Maybe okay at the other things, in case he's the sole developer. Designer, system. Oh, we got points that we can put into things, cool. So we can start either audio or 2D as kind of an art specialisation. Yep, more powerful now. I did turn out the laptop I had was throttled the download speeds too. Oh, okay. Wicked. So you're like just doing everything from that new PC now. That's all good. Yeah, I still wouldn't mind a bit faster internet, but streaming at 720p is fine, really, like, for the stuff I do, you know. I have tried playing a few modern games, like, I tried streaming some Cyberpunk from PC the other day, and that actually worked quite well, because the game's a bit more patched now, and works a bit better. Oh, there's too much to choose from. Artist, 2D or audio? I'll go with audio, because that's how I used to start. I don't know if that's a good thing now. Let's see. Program, audio... and system, and a bit of 2D, yeah. Designer, audio, same thing again. Nice, yeah. Do you have many other ideas for retro stuff you want to do? Or just, like, what have you mentioned so far, like, the old Ledger Shoot Larry, or one of them? I can't remember if you mentioned other things. The thing with retro is there's a lot of choice. you'll never run out of choice. It was like probably hundreds or thousands of games, I don't know. Older games, they're a lot easier to stream with little need for high speeds, yeah. Pretty much. Specializations, you can click random, no, I don't want to randomize that. I think we've done alright there. What's the point right now? You are now done customizing your founder, let's begin choosing the rules of the game. Alright, soon we'll actually start the game. Definitely want to get Larry going again, he's so cringe. Yeah, I've seen a few people stream them. Though not, didn't you mention number 5, I think? I don't think I've seen that one actually being streamed. Is my voice a bit croaky? I should have some more water. You can enable any mods here? Nah. You won't be able to... Okay, blah, blah. So yeah, I'm doing the tutorial because I haven't played this for a while. But yeah, Larry should be pretty easy to get running just with Scum VM. Think how much you want to start with. 25 grand by default, an additional fund to be loans. You need at least 50 grand if you would rather purchase an empty plot. I think we're going to start by renting like a shitty garage. Okay. Starting gear 1980, yeah. Usually starting in 1980, so you like the technology is a bit more basic, but it's also sort of simpler. Difficulty medium, maybe. What's the difference in difficulty? Difficulty can be changed at any point. Controls how easy it is to break into the market. Medium, I guess. Days per month, one day. That's default. And that seems to work. Okay, we're pretty much ready to start. If you feel like the game is going too fast, you can make it so a month. There's more days in a month, but one day to month seems like a not bad pacing, from what I recall. Pick map. Hey, what? You haven't used all your specialization points. Oh, there's some leader specialization points. Whoa. HR, automation, socialization, multitasking. Huh. Socialize with employees, handle education, SQL's iterations, frameworks, multitasking. Huh. I don't know. Yeah, the retro games from those years are some of your favourites, fair enough. Yeah, there's still a lot of love for those old adventure games. Or maybe I just follow those kind of people. But there's still quite a few people out there that like them. Especially the old Sierra one. Or Sierra and LucasArts mainly. But there's tons of other smaller companies. I guess want at least a point in everything. Socialize with employees. Is that important? I mean, it's probably important. Multitasking sounds good. Socialization and automation. We can always hire like an HR person to do all that kind of crap. Pick map. You haven't used all your specialization points. Oh, right, there's more of them. Jesus Christ. Service. Support marketing law. File for patent. Oh, wait. Handle external disputes. Oh, that's like things if like people are pirating your software, you can try and deal with it, I think. Marketing. Create press photos. I mean, I'll probably get people for marketing. Handle 2 support tickets. Chance to... Oh, each star rating is a different description. Chance to fix a bug. Probably just support. Like, we'll get lawyers and marketing people to do all that stuff. My guy doesn't have to be able to do everything, but support's good, you know, just be able to, like, fix your own stuff. So it seems like he's going to be good in a team, so we'll have to hire some people quite early on. But hopefully the tutorial will go over that, or else I kind of know how. Pick map. Garage Inc. I think we're going to have to start in that, or I've got this one I got from a mod, it's like a little home rental. Garage Inc. That's kind of a good starting one. Because we're just going to rent. But later we can like buy an empty plot and like build anything. Like you can build massive, like huge skyscraper things. I don't know. And end up with like dozens and dozens of employees. Little home rental. Garage Inc. Plainsville. Rent. Cost $480. Probably go with the I don't know if I should just go with the cheapest one. Rent out part of a skyscraper? Not the whole skyscraper. So did I end up posting pictures of the chicken that's decided to live at our house? I can't remember if I posted them on your Discord or not. Because she's quite funny. I gotta get some videos of her and Bernard playing. They like chase each other around. Bernard was like real scared of her for 2 weeks for no reason at all. Hey Eva, welcome in, how you going? We're playing Software Inc. and I was talking about the chicken. Who I think is very permanently living here now. Yeah, they're friends now. It just took Bernard like a couple of weeks to not be scared of her. But I don't even know why he was scared of her. Just because she's different, I guess. But apartment. I think we're going to start in the crappy little garage. Which we probably only own the garage, for, not even the whole house. How's it going, Eve Alicia? Would like to begin the welcome tutorial? Sure, why not? I haven't played this for ages. A lot of it controls a lot the Sims, like in terms of building and just camera controls. So I remember that much. You can drag this window somewhere else if it's in your way. Okay. Press continue to advance. Okay. You can move with WSAD, alright. Or hold the right mouse button. Okay, that's nice. WSAD works. You can rotate by using the middle mouse button. My scroll wheel doesn't actually work, but it seems like my middle mouse button does work. I should really get a new mouse. Jay Moyer, welcome in. How you going? What are we doing? Middle mouse, up, down, left, right. Okay, yep. Okay, I can scroll with keypad plus and minus. That works instead of scroll wheel. I wonder if I can set buttons, mouse button 4 and 5 for scrolling. Who cares, that's fine. About 25 grand, 10 AM, it's 1980. Good time to start a software company, I guess. Continue. Keys can be configured in the options menu. Or can I just quickly change them? Where's zoom? Camera zoom. Oh yeah, that can work. Zoom in, zoom out, mouse button 3 and 4. Okay. I've been changing that for a few games just because the scroll doesn't work, so I make it so the buttons on the mouse do the scrolling. Whee! The zooming. Well, there's a big car park there. I wonder if that's, like, anyone can use that if they want to work here. Don't know. We'll find out. I think, like, out of this whole house here, we just own this little garagey bit, which we'll be able to look into soon. Keys can be configured. Yep. Okay. Top left, find my current balance. So we're starting with 25 grand, and that's not a loan. That's, like, proper money. Real money. January 1980. Yep. There's a reputation, which is none. Angel Interceptor, how you going? Haven't seen you for like a quarter of an hour. I was just doing a quiz on... What do you call it, quiz? Yeah, it was like a pub quiz on Angel's channel just about half an hour ago. Concerning all sorts of topics. Some gaming related, some completely not gaming related. Yeah, that was good fun. Even if I didn't win. Been longer than that, surely. Okay, it's been like 45 minutes, maybe, I don't know. You can hover over the bar to see what's currently blah blah blah. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going through the tutorial of this for anyone new here. Been longer, yeah. You can improve your business reputation by doing contract work. Oh, yeah, that's right. So you don't even have to make your own software at first, you can just do contract work just to make a bit of money, really. So I'll probably do that soon. The game's paused at the moment. You can see how much money is moving in and out. Oh yeah, there's like my cash flow, which is nothing. Game speed, we can adjust with numbers, just like the Sims. A lot of it's very Simsy, apart from you're trying to make money off software, which you can probably actually do in the Sims as well. Important notifications will appear. Yep, that's fine. Controls are down here, so it's just saying there are some buttons down here. Okay. Remember, you can always restart the tutorial. Yep, okay, finish. Now what? Is it in a tutorial? I don't know. Go down one floor. Okay, so that's what we start with. Oh, we get a free heater. I don't even have to pay. Oh, is that a heater or is that just like a water cylinder? What is that? Looks like a heater. Because you need to worry about temperature being suitable and noise. You don't want things to be too noisy or else people will bitch about it. And stuff like that. Now I can bring down the walls, like that. Cool. So I think this is all we own, is this tiny garage. And it comes with some attached loos, which I guess people can use, but I can't change them. But that's just fine. Right, if it's not going to directly tutorial me, I'm just going to have to start making some stuff for my founder, because we have one person working for the company so far. Develop software? No, we want to build stuff. Build mode. Would you like to begin the leasing tutorial? Yeah? Is it like leasing stuff? When you own a plot, you can construct the layout of your offices however you like, but when you're leasing, you can only furnish the office you're currently leasing. Well, fair enough. Let's put some furniture in our room. Yes, a desk, a table. So it's like table isn't like a desk, pretty much. A chair. No, I want more desk. Alright, a chair. That one, you reckon? Ergonomics, bad. Oh. Ergonomics, less bad. I found I should probably have a half-decent chair. Right? That's a bit more expensive, but that's good. Oh, screw it. He's the founder. He can have a fancy chair. I'm just going to waste all my money on nice furniture. Probably. Finally, add a computer. Nah, not much choice of computer so far, because it's 1980, so we get an old computer. It has a flammability chance of 5%. I don't know how often that's a factor. And it takes up quite a bit of electricity, because it's old. And old stuff did that. There we go, it's like an all-in-one thing. Seemingly. Is that monitor attached? Yeah. When you put tables next to each other, they'll be grouped together. If they don't have anything on top of them, tables that are grouped together can be used for meetings. Alright, yeah. You can make, like, meeting rooms later. I don't think we're quite going to have the space for a meeting room at the moment. So, it's important you control the noise levels in your working environment. Yeah, even things like a coffee machine, like the best coffee machines people like, but they don't like the fact that they're noisy, so you can put them in different rooms. Data overlay. Whoa. Okay. I can just check all, I don't know, all sorts of things. Satisfaction. Oh, you get all sorts of different, what do you call, heat maps. Stress. Lighting. Lighting is okay. Temperature is okay, I guess. Germs. Do we have germs? I guess that's okay. Water. None, maybe. Noise. Oh yeah, it shows you everything that's noisy. So even a door makes a bit of noise, and a toilet obviously makes a bit of noise. Computer makes a bit of noise. What else? Oh, is that the door that it's showing, or something else? Or something on the wall there? Oh, there's probably a vent there. Oh well, you actually have to, like, even ventilate the places. It's, yeah. Quite a bit of things to look after. Now let's assign the room to a team. Employees from other teams may then not use it or even pass through it. Whoa, okay. Right-click the new room and choose which team. We only have the one team, which is my one person, and it's the core team. And you can make it so others allow to pass through if you want. Okay. Okay, press shift left mouse button on object rooms employees to select several at once. Okay. You can lease other rooms by selecting them and pressing lease. Oh, cool. So, does this house let me lease other rooms? Nice. So, when I need, like, an extra room for, like, I don't know, marketing or something, they can go in there. Rad. Build mode. When you're ready, open the employees window to start managing your employees. Okay. We've got 4 NATO. He's kind of going to have to do everything for now. See, look, it's me. Looks exactly the same. Select multiple, yeah, you just told me that. Oh no, control left click while dragging the mouse. Oh well. List of all my employees, you can check out the options bar to get more details. Okay. Well, what do you want me to do? Ah, continue. When you select an employee on the list, they'll be selected and the game gives you details. Yeah. Details. Okay. So, it says details. There's not much going on, I guess, yet. Try selecting another employee now. What other employee? Maybe I should hire some, but do I need them? You can select several employees by holding a shift. Okay, now press right mouse button anywhere to bring up a context menu for the selected employee. Cool. And tell him what team to go on. Switch team. He's on the core team already. That's fine. When you're done, okay, press mouse button and change employee role. Okay. Cool. Is he the leader? Should he be the leader? I don't know. I'll probably eventually hire a proper leader so that they can be better at delegating tasks. Click the role in the role menu of assigning employees exclusively to that role immediately. Yep. The second row of check marks is your secondary option. Okay. All right. So if they have no work in the primary role, they can then do some secondary stuff. I guess for now is everything. Note that leader can't be chosen unless the employee is assigned to a team, and leaders won't work in full capacity in other roles. Okay. Close the select role thing, blah blah blah, continue, nice. Alrighty. With your employee selected, press right mouse button again to bring up the context. Employee details. Is that what I just looked at? Probably. You can see the stats of your employee. Next point. What's that? Employee specialized progress in each role. When an employee has filled their progress meter, okay, so they can just like level up and get better at stuff. Dramatic and optimistic, which I don't even know if that describes me in real life exactly, or even at all. But it worked for the sake of this game's stats. I'm not that dramatic, am I? Look at a role, will allow you to assign the employee to that role. Cool, where are the roles? Spinari is going to be the leader of himself. There's the specializations, which I know because I just decided them myself about 10 minutes ago. Basic skills employees experience in that role, which controls the speed and quality of their work. Okay. This game is going to have a lot of talking if I'm reading out everything, isn't it? Oh well, I got water and wine, so that works. Even though it's still the morning. Yeah, it's only like 11 o'clock, but oh well. I got up very early today, because I went to bed very early last night. And that's because I went to bed very late the night before, so I had to catch up and get back to normal. I went to bed at like 9 p.m. last night. On the left, you can see the employee's traits. Yep, okay. In the bottom left, you can see the latest thoughts. Satisfaction. Does that mean he's satisfied, or? I don't know. You should inspect this often to see how well an employee is doing and whether you can do anything to improve their satisfaction. Okay. Effectiveness. Okay, that shows us effectiveness. You can see what is wrong with your employees. So like, if something's pissing them off, you can find out. Does that show pop-ups? Like, it just showed me a pop-up in the bottom right when someone came onto Steam. Does that show on the stream? Not sure, because it probably shouldn't. And I might be able to disable that somehow. Like, you know, the normal Steam notifications where it tells you what your friends are doing. But, well, people that I know on Steam that may or may not be my friends. Finally, in the middle left of the window, you can inspect the employee's compatibility with the rest of their team. Oh, that's right, that becomes a big factor. You can't hire too many different personality types or else, you know, they don't like working together and all that kind of real-life drama kind of stuff. That happens. In the beginning of the game, you'll need to make some quick cash. Bring up the contracts window. Nice, let's do it. You can actually make a fair bit of money here. Like, even get your first couple hundred grand or so. And then really invest that into a project. This is a list of available contracts. This is, doing stuff for other people. Just what, much money. Have an upfront payment you'll receive for accepting the work and a bigger payment for completing it. You can get a contract by delivering the product with the requested progress and quality. Try selecting a contract. What's this one that pays the most? Embedded systems. It says here they expect the work to be metacore, or the quality to be metacore, meaning that's, you know, just, it doesn't have to be amazing. And they recommend one designer and one programmer, but can that be the first same person? Minimum progress 26%, so you can just half-ass it, or in this case quarter-ass it, I guess, and that's fine. Cost per bug, $39. Okay, let's try it, unless I want to do a different one that doesn't need as much. Nah, screw it, we'll try and get this 10 grand. Since I've already lost a bit of money, well, spent a bit of money. I wouldn't say lost, invested. No one is competent as a level 0 systems designer in the selected teams. Are you sure, or maybe not then? Fine. Did I say that? You need 0? I don't know. Isn't Ebron a level zero systems designer? Because it's level zero. Logistics applications. Oh, they're saying they're right, what they need. Features, clock. Oh, okay, so that's what I'm actually making. System any level. System any level. 2D any level. Or is my guy actually not in the core team? I might have accidentally took him out before. Team, none. Yeah, let's put him back in that team. Royal might have made me remove him from that team. Right, that's better. Now can we do it? Or is he still not good at... I don't know. Is he in that team? Or... Okay, we're going to try it anyway. Programmer is zero. Why is he not a programmer? Come on. Where is he? Where is he? Employee role. Oh, why did that all untick? Okay, that's probably better. He can do stuff. Designer and programmer first. Secondary is artist and service. Okay. Now, is that better? Cool. We accepted a contract. We already got 2.5 grand. But now we have to get him in here to do it. So I think this room is it's got this basic furnishings, like lights. Not that you can see them at the moment. But if you're building up your own place that you're not renting, you have to like have lights, windows, vents, all sorts. Is there a nice big window here or something? Put the walls up and down. I don't know. Toggle walls. Oh yeah, we've got a nice wide window. That view's alright. The walls aren't really too disruptive at the moment. Okay, to start developing, need to piece together a design document. So a lot of this, he'll do it automatically as long as he's assigned the right roles. So let's see. Design phase is split up into iterations. Each iteration increases the potential and quality and decreases the speed and amount of bugs in your project. So yeah, you want to have a good design phase so that the actual making the software phase can go smoothly. There are two ways to tackle design phase. You can finish one iteration and handle any issues in the development phase, or you can finish all iterations and have less issues in the development phase. So remember, this doesn't have to be a perfect quality, they're only expecting mid-core quality, really. First method is very effective, but makes it hard to estimate how long development will take. Oh, right. However, the second method is guaranteed to extend the design phase exponentially. Ah. That would probably, in the end, give you better software, I guess. Continue. Until an employee actually starts working on the contract, the deadlines will not count down. The tutorial will continue once you move to the next phase of development. Okay. So, now we actually start the workday. So, we're going to come in. Everyone has come in by, like, I don't know, bus or car or whatever. Come on. Oh, I can skip until... Oh, yeah, I have to wait until the next day, apparently. Okay. Where's he going to come? There we go. So he'll just get on it. That starts very basic. He's just typing he's typing ABC, pretty much. And it's on iteration 1. I can speed that up a bit. Do we want to do two iterations? Iteration 2. Nah, we're just going to develop. So, I think that blue line's the quality line that probably says here. When the process bar matches the blue line, you have lived up to the contract's progress requirements, okay? However, you still need to meet the quality requirements if you want to increase your business reputation and receive better contracts. Okay. Make sure you do a client review before you move on to the bug fixing stage to make sure you meet their quality requirements. Well, this tutorial will continue once you start a review. So it's technically good enough quality for them. I could give it a little bit more, you know, goodness. And just to impress the employees. But we'll go review. The review of Deluxe, I guess that's what the software's called. I can either do it myself or outsource, which costs money, but we're just going to do it ourselves. Assign, promote, review. Sorry, he's reviewing it while he develops it. Okay. 10 reviews finished. Did he do 10 himself? Overall score, well, they only asked for medical, so 3.5 out of 10 might be okay. iterate. So, now what? When you're ready, let's move on to bug fixing phase. What are we doing now, though? Iterating. It's impossible to know exactly how many bugs in a piece of software has, so just try to fix as many as you can before time runs out. Okay. Finish your contact work to end the tutorial. Right. Assign. Assign. Oh, that's already... That's fine. End. I guess I just end it once I've fixed enough bugs. Or did you fix any bugs? I don't know. End. Motes. Oh yeah, now we're in the bug fix phase. So we'll let him do that for a little bit. It's still we're still on the same day, but one day is like a month. Fix 5 bugs, fix 6 bugs, that'll do. Are you sure you want to release back Deluxe now? Okay, done. Yeah, they gave me the apparently it was outstanding quality. I don't know if that means it's actually outstanding or just compared to what they wanted, it's outstanding. But now he's got nothing to do. So we'll pause the game for now. And I guess grab another contract. Contracts. I don't know how much money I'll... Like, I'll maybe get 100 grand before he starts his own software. I don't know. What else have we got? Some more 10 grand stuff. Logistics application. 31, 34, 28. Oh, that's easy enough. This person just wants a clock. And not even an incredible clock. Just a medical clock. No, a bad. They'll even pay for a bad clock. 10 grand. Yeah, take it. How do I accept work? There. Right. You'll start on the clock. And... done one iteration. Could let him do two. Why not? We'll try this one a bit differently. He'll probably have to go home, though, at some point. Right, that's enough iterations. Assign. No, not assign. Promote. Develop. Yes. Make it good. Also do some reviewing. You can just do both at the same time, pretty much. Nick Car Corporation. Lock. Reviews, 3 out of 10, so... Well, they ask for bad, so they're gonna get bad. Or maybe they'll even get okay. Pause elf work to improve the design of your software and increase the potential end quality. Or how about no? How about we'll just promote this and bug fix. Fixed one bug, fixed 2 bugs. He has to go home. Speed up until he gets back the next day. Oh, that's right. He even makes a mess on the floor, so we have to deal with that at some point. It gets worse when you have employees, of course. Fixed 3 bugs. How many bugs have we fixed? Like 5? Actually, we're going to have less bugs because we, you know, did 2 iterations in the design phase. Cool. 42 grand. And I'm of course paying money each month just to rent the place. More contract work for now. And I won't do too many of these because that's gonna get quite repetitive. I wanna start expanding, I guess. This game can get a bit tedious. And when we wanna watch something that's more action packed, then, you know, let us know and we'll play some Noiter and other stuff. Embedded systems, clock. We could do another clock. People like their clocks. They want a horrible quality clock. I can deliver that, I think. I can definitely do that for them. One iteration from a company called Sheepswitch. Don't exactly want to know what they do. But all I know is they need a clock. Alright, give them some average quality crap. And do a little review for them. Check the reviews, it's probably like 2 out of 10. That's pretty much what they asked for, I think. And promote, let's do some bug fixes. There's going to be a few more bugs in this, maybe we'll get 5. Come on, 5th bug. There we go. Finish. Yes. Done, that's what they wanted. Cool. We can maybe knock out 2 in a day, but depends on how thorough I want to be with each one. Embedded systems, they want a horrible quality clock as well. I could just hire a second employee who could just sit here making shitty clocks all day. That might actually make some money. Alright. The Pit Sausage Incorporated. One iteration. Done. Develop. Blah 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 blah. Type. Done. Well, pretty much. You 2019. What's this? Like 3 out of 10? 3.7 out of 10. Nice. Remote, fix some bugs, another 5 or so. Oh, that'll do, finish. Gonna have to go home soon anyway. Cool, outstanding quality. Why do I keep giving them outstanding quality when they're... cool. Shit. And next day. Right. Do I start on something on my own? If I got enough money to keep the rent flowing while I'm doing it. And also, you know, pay for other expenses that'll pop up. I might get at least one more contract done just to get a bit more money under the belt. Logistics application, they want a command line, that's bad. You specialize in horrible to bad software. So that's fine. But what kind of software should I make? Or make him make, you know? I guess at first it should be something basic. He has, we're gonna do two iterations just cause. He has some skills in audio software, so we might go that direction. Right, review, promote, review, end, blah blah blah. Well, I'm making things that are too good quality. right, fix some bugs. There's not going to be too many. Finish. Nice. 73 grand. We can maybe start working on something of our own. It's probably going to start another tutorial. Would you like to begin this simple design document tutorial? Yes, because that sounds new. Oh no, that's just what they call this phase. So yeah, this is where it starts getting a bit more interesting, hopefully. Welcome to the design document, the heart of Software Inc. This is where you decide what kinds of software you want to make. Start by picking a software type, right? Not an operating system, because that requires, you know, skill. Audio tool, perhaps? Expected interest. Oh yeah, it tells you, like, just based on the current market, like, what the interest is in different things, you know. So 24%. Doesn't sound like heaps, but it's a lot better than 11%. Game. Expected interest for games is... well, it depends on the genre. No, maybe not. Not much interest in games. It seemed like audio tool would be good. Office software? No. Audio tool. Because it's the early 80s. Everyone likes making audio on the computer in the 80s, I guess. Right, category, default price. So that's like the market average price. So I can try and like undercut that a bit to get more sales, or whatever, you know, overcut it to get more profit. Start by picking a software type, yep. If applicable, you can pick a category, but there's no categories for this one. What's Bernard doing? Then pick a name. Oh, right, what's the name? I don't know. I can do like an 80s version of Winamp or something. Just like a basic kind of audio player that's not too complicated. Because it already says here that it's going to take, or they think it'll take a couple of years. Jesus. Cat's just jump kicked a empty beer box. Okay, that's fine. He's being a bit silly. Yeah, like it says here how many, like they recommend 4 programmers, which I don't currently have, but I might have to get some more. And an artist. Like that artist isn't like a sound artist. Not a graphical artist. And then if I add more features, that, you know, it's just gonna add all sorts of more technology. I'd even tell you the tech level, like, but if I add no features, the tech level will be from 1975. So it'll seem like a 5-year-old piece of software. What are we calling it then? I don't know. Waramp, why not? It's probably not going to be incredible. We're going to charge a bit under the market value. Original IP. Oh no, that's if you want to make like a sequel. And you can actually make software that's in-house, so like, you can make a game engine that only your company can use if you want, and like, not sell it to other people. We don't have a server to store it all on. We don't have a source management control, I don't believe. But, do we need more people? Kind of does definitely imply we want more people. Hey there, Moth Seraph, how are you going? Got some dinner so I can actually not be too distracted to chat. Cool, how you going? What's for dinner? Who knows if this game will interest you or not. It's about programming. Well, it's about making a software company, so there's no actual programming in it. It's still. It's a little bit like The Sims, though, in a way, but with more software stuff. Can I make something simple so that doesn't need that many people? It's not much interest in antivirus, even though they're simple. Damn. Operating systems are hard. I really should be making a audio tool, it seems. Okay. But I'm going to have to hire some people while I'm making it, I guess. Good, got some Subway semis, yum. Could receive a gift card in the mail. Oh, cool. Or like a random one, or do you like, have you like signed up to get some random gift cards? Because either way, not bad. Oh yeah, pick a name, 4amp, because it's like Winamp, but 1980. So yeah, I'm starting a software company in someone's garage that I don't even own myself in 1980. And so we're starting from the ground up pretty much. And see how rich we can get. See how long it takes to become a millionaire. Right, hopefully we've got enough money to hire some employees. We've got a name, a price. If you leave the price field alone, price will be picked based on the software and features you've chosen. So yeah, it's going to slightly cheapen it to 22. Okay. Right, look at features. You can pick up your product. I'm probably not going to really have any features, like barely. Because that's just going to add a lot more development time. I've only got one employee, which is me there. So, rewards from health insurance for doing a survey. Oh, cool. Blah blah blah. Software just divided into specializations. Okay. Features that are highlighted in red are unavailable because you don't have any employees. Do I want any basic features for this audio program? Channel mixer? Because even just clicking that might add, it'll recommend that I have an extra programmer just for that. But it'll make the expected interest go from 24 to 41. That's quite a jump. There's all these other little features here that each help. Now you can have 80s auto-tune. I like the description, it just says, this is a thing. Okay. Do those all have descriptions or just that one? That's weird. Most of these have no descriptions apart from auto-tune is a thing. Dunbank. That wants more artists. Synthesizer presets. Synthesizer, whoa. That requires a lot more work, but people would enjoy it more. I don't know. I should add at least a feature just so the interest level goes up to, you know, more than 24%. Channel mixer. Even just channel mixer could be better than nothing. Okay. Blah blah. So yeah, I'm kind of going through the tutorial here, so it's a bit slow. But one star features are simple features that help satisfy. Oh, okay, so these are different quality levels. Simple features that help satisfy submarkets to a lesser degree. Two stars are more effective at satisfying the target audience. Okay, that makes sense. Three star features don't satisfy your target audience, but instead modify your software in some way. Okay. Okay, so even though it's three stars you'd think would satisfy the target audience, it just doesn't necessarily. Two-star features, like, they're going to take me a lot more time. And this is our first bit of software that we're actually making, so we're not going to go nuts. We're just going to make something pretty average. So consumer reach here will be about 1.7 million, potentially, you know. They're not all going to buy it. But if I don't have the channel mixers that go down... Oh, no, it's the same... Yeah. Even if we just sold to like 10% of that amount group of people, that could be quite a bit of money. Okay. As you may have noticed, each main feature has a tech level associated with it. Yeah. Oh, like the tech, the year. 1974 tech level. That's amazing. Can we go down in tech? How's that work? Yeah, well, I better read. A main tech level associated. The tech levels can be researched by you or other companies from year to year. Sticking to the latest tech level will increase your target audience satisfaction and the marketability of your product. Right. But increase development time. Oh. Okay. Tech level 1970. No. We're in 1980, so we want the tech level to be as high as we can, I guess. You caught part of me setting up the character. Oh, yeah. I was just... Yeah, that was just mainly cosmetic stuff, but also choosing, like, his specializations. for my character. But I'm going to be hiring a lot of other characters, so he's just one of potentially many, so it doesn't matter too much. It's worth noting that the maximum tech level is limited by any tools needed during development. Right. So I don't even have modern tools, because they're probably not many of them exist yet. Continue. I can make it an original IP, which just means that I'm making it a sequel to something, which I'm not, because this is my first thing ever. Reminds me of the lemonade stand I have way back when, mixed with Sims. Yeah, it's a very Simsy interface, like just the way, even the way you build and like, I don't know, do a lot of other things is quite Sims-like, which is just to make it kind of intuitive. Like, it's quite simple to build things. Features that were implemented in the predecessor product will be highlighted in orange, so that's fine, we're not making a sequel. Publisher. Oh. If you're worried about how to pay your developers, how much physical copies you have to order, or how much effort to put into marketing, you can sign up with a publisher. They will handle these details. That could be an idea. I don't know. Well, it doesn't really tell me if it's a good idea or not. Because otherwise I'll have to like physically make, because since it's 1980, you can't make software that's sold digitally, because it's 1980, you know, people don't have the internet. Ugg stand game. And yeah, so, like, yeah, we'll have to actually physically print boxes and print this, whatever, I was going to say CDs, but it's 1980, so they're going to be on big ass floppy disks. So I might actually end up needing a publishing company. Or maybe I could just hire companies just to do the printing. We'll see. For now, we'll say no publisher. We'll self-publish. Recommended designers 3, programmers 5, recommended artists 1. We currently have one person who can do both of the top 2 things and kind of do the bottom one. So might have to hire at least another 3 people in this cramped little garage, which I'll see in a second. That's all the room you have right now. But I can put some more desks along here and hopefully get some people that work well together. Make sure I inspect the information box. Yeah, I've been keeping an eye on that. License cost. So I have to pay... Okay, so I have to pay $741 per month just to license out the software to make this, I guess. Operating system seats. How much you'll have to pay for operating system licenses for each employee to develop? Alright. Well, it's better make us some money then, because we've only got $73,000. If we get desperate, we'll do more contracts. Yeah. Having more than a suggested amount of employees on development will result in diminishing returns. Okay. You're paying more in salaries, but getting a smaller and smaller speed increase. Right. And return. After you went through the phases of deployment and are ready, remember to see if any popular products have just been released in the same software category. Oh, right. Because there might be some stiff competition, like if someone else has just made, like, it doesn't look like there's much been released yet, because we've just started the kind of game. June. Oh yeah, and it tells you what things are expected to be coming out, I guess. Because people, like, have already marketed them, and, like, you know, even though they haven't come out yet, you start marketing software. But, let's see, hopefully no one's planning to make some audio software in the future. Office software, antivirus, Office. Someone is making an audio tool, so I've got at least one competition there, but it still should be worth it. Well, hopefully. Can I go down this list? 1980. And in May, there's some other stuff coming out. Some adventure game. Some operating systems. But that's cool. No one's making too many audio software, so hopefully I'll corner that market a little bit. You got the events calendar. Right, timing is everything when you're just starting out. Yeah. So there's a bit of a sort of a luck factor, but you can look what's being advertised and look around that. Develop. What's Advanced going to do? If you want to dive deeper into dependencies, framework, and market targeting, you can switch to the Advanced version. What's this do? Well, I'll have a quick skim through this. I'm probably not going to need this yet. Framework panel. You can use or create a framework when developing software. They speed up development, but lock down the maximum tech levels of your features. Using a framework made by another company will require you to pay a license fee. If you decide to create a framework, okay, how about we will not do that? The advanced design document has multiple pages. Okay, well. This is all new stuff since I last played, which is probably a year ago. Because this game is still in development as well. Your product can depend on other software types, right? 2D editor. Alright, so you can choose, like, it needs a 2D editor just to be able to make this. I can choose which one I use. Vector Pro, I don't know if it defaults to choose the best one or the most recent one. Let's have a look. Because you can check out the, like, the quality level of each one. Why have they got explanation marks? Most software also needs to run on one or more operating systems. Ah, okay. So I have to decide what operating systems this will be made for, I think. If there's even much choice right now. So Vector Pro or Vector Pro 2 are good and or great qualities. Shall I go with Vector Pro 2? Because it's better. So at the moment we're making things for the Opti operating system. I don't even know what else is out there. Vector Pro 2. Cool. That sounds fancy. Operating systems Opti 3. Right, so Opti 3 is the current, like, most popular by far operating system. So it's, I'll probably just make it for that. And not worry about all these silly little operating systems. Pen Slim OS and whatnot. It came out in, well, they all came out in the 70s. Because the 80s has just started. It'd be cool if I could just put on some, like, background music from the year of when it came out, of, like, when the game is set, and, like, but, you know, that'd be kind of, that'd probably get me a copyright strike. But I probably can't do that. Right, making it for Opti 3. You can port your software to all other operating systems after, right, if we want, or if one of them becomes popular or a new one comes out. Okay, next page. Ooh, okay. This is all new. What's this nice colourful triangle? The submarket triangle lets you decide how your how to market and design efforts will be weighted to target a section of users on the market. Alright. So, interesting. Market satisfaction. The market's not going to be overly satisfied unless we really specialise in one direction, I guess. You could either decide what markets you want to target and pick features that will satisfy them, or pick the features you want to target. Okay, the three bars at the bottom will show you how well... Is this something I can actually change? Right. I probably won't play around with that left yet. Three bars at the bottom show you how well your chosen features satisfy each market. Okay. Oh, so this is just analysing, like, sort of trends, like, say... I don't know exactly. Okay. Only one page left, yay. Summary page, and this is where I can choose a publisher, which I probably won't do. Click the develop button when you're ready to begin development. And develop. Yeah, he's got a shitload to do if he's going to do it by himself, which I don't think he will. 20 degrees Celsius, that's a nice temperature, for anyone wondering. It's getting a little warm, maybe, but it's not like, it's not hot. It's actually probably quite pleasant for most people. And there is a light on that toilet, it's just turned off. Okay, that's fine. When you work on a design document, so yeah, he's not even making the software yet, he's just doing the design document, which is going to take its time by itself. You should start telling the world about your new project. So even right now, you can start your marketing, even though this thing won't be out for like 2 years. You'll have to do some guesswork when picking a release date, but at least it will increase the effectiveness of all your future marketing efforts. Okay. But of course, that takes, like, marketing takes time. It's not just like an instant thing. Announce release date. It told me about 2 years if I get the right number of employees. I guess I'll assume 2 years. Yeah, that's what it defaults to. Announce release date. Okay, are you sure you're... So this action is instant, actually. Just announcing the release date. And then, so that's nice. You will have 2 years and 1 month to release the product. Right, we'll see what we can do. Market. Okay. Before you move on to the alpha phase, you should make a press release to tell the world about your product. So that'll take a bit of time. When you market your product before it's released, you build a following. It's probably needed. Well, it's going to help. Your employees will have to work on making the press release. So, if you think it'll take a while, you can pause your design work. Alright. Yeah, he might want to just work on that for a bit. Press release. So we can do a text one, a picture, or a video. Text is fine. We're only making an audio tool. and we don't have heaps of money or other things. No one is competent as level 1 marketer in the selected teams. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes, but I might have to get a marketer and some other programmers. Yeah, okay. Right, let's go to our build mode and get some more stuff. Hey Presto PPC, how you going? I'm pretty good. You seen this game before? I'm not actually sure how common or popular it is, but I thought I'd give it another go. Right, we're gonna make some more desks for more peoples to work at. We have a marketing guy in the corner, maybe some more programmers and stuff over here. Maybe a desk in the middle for some stuff. Like, we'll see. Bathroom break room common. Who's our office tools? Office. Click develop to, yeah, we'll do that when we're ready. Right, what was I gonna put in here? Good, thanks, nice. Do we even have a wall clock? Can't not have a wall clock. People have to know how long they have to keep working for. Table plant. Okay, it's a tiny little bonsai tree thing. Bonsai. Right, that's nice. Bookshelf, complete with books. Oh, cool. Sweet. Oh, and I can put things on people's desks that that give them slight productivity boosts. Like a marketing person would like a phone, but of course they're noisy because, well, they had to talk. Drawing tablet, calculator, or inbox. You could just have a little inbox. We're gonna need more computers for these people. Old 80s computers, because what else do we have a choice of? I guess they want a chair, that's probably why they have an exclamation mark. Oi. Okay. Marketing can have a telephone. I guess we'll try and get at least one artist to have a drawing tablet, which doesn't seem like a very 80s thing to have, but apparently we have it. And some programmers, so they can have calculators, because, you know, apparently they don't have that app built into their computer. Sneaky watch it work? Yeah. Right. There they go. Their computers are on a nice jaunty angle there. So now I'm going to have to actually employ people. Because this guy's not going to make a piece of software by himself. All he's going to make is a mess on the floor by himself. What else do we need while we're here though? Desk lamp. Or localized lighting improvements. Nah, we've got lighting. Painting. Do you want a painting up there somewhere? Nice, it's just a painting of a tree. Okay, that's fine. TV from 1995? Nope. We're in 1980. What else? Do we want like a nice big plant in the corner? Yes. And then probably soon they're going to want things like coffee machines and stuff. Common canteen. Could get some basic coffee machine. But they have noise factor. Not that they're going to be used all the time, but I guess when they are used, they're just going to be noisy. Quality. Some crap coffee. It's a bit noisy, but with people are definitely going to want coffee. You no doubt about that. Oh, you're watching at work. I thought you meant you were watching these guys at work. Okay, I won't tell your boss. Since I know him or her personally, you know. I guess we go on to the hiring. Don't really need to buy too much more. Kitchen. Oh, that's right, you can actually have a whole like kitchen and in-house kind of thing. Fridge. Generates food for cooks to cook. Okay. Oh yeah, can I have like a vending machine? I think I can. So then people can just get some food at least. But do I have room for a vending machine in this tiny garage? Maybe. Could have that instead of a plant for now. Might be the main option. Or over here, that could work. Right, we're not going to be able to place much more though. We could maybe make some better floor. Does that actually cost? Room colours? Select building floor. Okay, room colours. Oh, that's the wall colour. What's a nice wall colour? Soothing kind of a work environment wall colour. Some kind of blue. Yeah. Floor colour. Black to hide the stains? I don't know. Red, green, I don't know. Reddish. Kind of looks like big tiles. Yeah, that'll do for now. Okay, back to play mode. Now, so he's currently working on, well, the very first design document for the audio software and a bit of marketing for it, which I really need to hire someone to do. Right, let's hire someone. Hire employees. Do you want to begin the hiring tutorial? I think I'm okay. Not now. Role. Marketer. Or service, I think that's marketing. Specialization. Marketing. Salary. I guess we're starting with low because, you know, we're a poor little company. Interview for overall skill and personality. And choose if we want to put much more money into looking for them. A little bit of money. Right. The skill levels are all bad. We mainly want someone at the moment that's compatible with our team. Because you can tell them what team to go straight into. We can get someone here that's great compatibility. Or straight off the bat. That's fine. He is not great at too much. Hope he can do a little bit of marketing here. The money that I'm paying, I can't expect too much. He's a generous flirt. Okay, that's fine. Apparently that's compatible with my guy, who's a dramatic, optimist? blah blah blah. Right. Hire. You have limited funds to sustain your company if you hire him. Are you sure you want to continue? Yes. I'm probably going to have to do more contract work while this thing is being made. Just so we can afford it. Alright. Then we maybe want some designers and programmers. Although maybe we should wait until we're in the programming phase before we get programmers. But I could get another design guy. Guy or gal. So, designer. Specialization. Guess we can go audio. Salary low, skill. Right, they're all pretty average skill, but we just want something with good compatibility. Good enough. Good. It's good. Very bad. Good. That's good. This skill level all going to be pretty average. Alright, pretty good. The top one then. So they'll probably come in like the next day. So we'll speed this guy through today. Right, now look, we have more people and more mess on the floor. Hey, where's my guy? My guy went over there? No. You go. Silly asshole. Goes here. I think you can assign. I don't even know why he changed computers, but he probably just went to the closest one when he came in. And then they like to put a gap between themselves, apparently. I suppose that makes sense, because people are noisy. People on computers make a bit of noise. So they want a bit of a gap. I can put partitions up, but I don't know if I have room for them. Assign furniture to employee. Four. Okay. Will you get up and use it then? Yep. He'll just walk through that desk and go over there. And that's technically where I wanted the artist to sit. Are you the marketer? Because that'd be nice if you're sitting at the right desk. Manage employees. Right, who are these people? Design, programmer, artist. Okay. Service. Donovan. Alright, that's good. That's Donovan. That can be Donovan's computer. This can be the other person's computer here. Oh, there. Cecil. Where'd he go? Did he just go and get some food from out there? How did he do that? Doesn't he want to use my vending machine? I'm not sure where he got that food from. Looked like he came back with food. Or was that from the vending machine? Did he give him a plate? That's nice of them. Where's he going? Probably just on his break, I guess. Oh yeah, I didn't really give them much anywhere to sit for their break, so they can go out there if they want. Whoa, he didn't sit down. Right, let's make sure these people are specialising in what they should be specialising in. Look at that mess. We're going to have to hire a cleaner at the end of the day. Or it's too shitty in here. Right, manage employees. Donovan, skill. Change roles. Service. Right, Cecil, and Rose, he's a designer. I guess he can be a programmer secondary. Maybe an artist as well, I don't know. And Fornado should be doing mainly the... Man, it's gonna take a while just to make that first press release. Fuck, how many employees should I have made for this? Who knows if I even chose a good piece of software to make first, but it's alright, we'll just... play this for a bit and then play something that's actually exciting. Where's he going? He keeps getting food and then not knowing where to sit down and... Go on, if you want to go and eat, then go and eat. Just don't mess around. You're on the payroll. Go on, sit down. No! Why is he... I don't know. Do I have to rent this area? I don't know. And then he goes to sit down there, and then he stands up again. He's just stuck in a weird loop. I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. It's like he doesn't want to sit at this place. What if I put a chair there so they could sit at this desk and just maybe eat there? I don't know. Will he sit there? I don't know. No, he's just gonna keep doing that same shit. What the hell's going on? Time to invest in a whip. Hey, Seacross, how you going? Yeah. I don't know if this is a bug or something I've done wrong. This game has been around for a little while though now. It shouldn't be too buggy. It's like he's kind of treating this room as the canteen, or where he goes to sit down to eat, but then he doesn't sit down to eat. Can I check what the hell's wrong with this guy? State. At work. Status at work. Right. Yeah. Well, maybe this is something I have to try and figure out off stream and then come back to this game at some point. I don't know. How do I get details? Happy with the salary, happy with his benefits, nice. Environment he's fine with, room aura is fine, not great, just fine. Hunger. Just eat it. Eat it! Or is he just getting up every few minutes just to eat? Because I don't think I own this area, so I can't, even if he can access it, I can't change it, I don't think. Two rewards, okay. Make 50 grand from contracts. Claim reward. What's that? It's a box. An ergonomic chair and a yoga ball, which I have no room to place. Okay, thanks. And another reward? Hire your first employee. Claim reward. Present. A desk and a modern desk. Okay. As opposed to these shitty little tables that I'm using. But they look like they're bigger than a shitty little table. Why? What's his problem? Why? What if I have no vending machine? How would he deal with that? Or I'll take this thing away, maybe then he can use this table? No! I mean, maybe because this room isn't designated as a cafeteria, he won't just eat in it. I really don't know. Let's hire a cleaner to get rid of all these footprints these filthy animals leave here. Manage staff. No, we don't need a staff tutorial. We want to call cleaning, but not hire cleaning, because at the moment we're just going to pay them by the hour until we have more money. I guess they can just come in during the day. No, they're going home now anyway. We'll see if the next day he comes and doesn't fuck up. Employee request, what does it... He wants a wage negotiation already. Fucking hell, alright. Now, oh, he's doing it again. Is that the same guy? He's sitting down and using it. Okay, that's good. That's actually good. I don't know what changed. I mean, we don't really need this here. And we can put a plant on the desk. Maybe. Floor plant, desk plant, table, we'll put a table cactus. Why not? Okay, so now he's back to work properly. And now my marketing is actually going up a bit. That's nice. And so we've got two guys working on the design documents. And yeah, I think kind of soon we might even start doing so playing some Noita, because that's just something that's a bit more of a normal game that should be a bit more exciting. I thought I'd give this a go after, you know, since it's been in development for another year since I last played it. Man, do I need two marketing people just to get this design document out? I mean, not the design document, the press release. Design document's going okay. Almost need a cleaner every day. Yeah. Alright. Text. How long is that going to take for just a design document? I could hire another marketer, but that's, you know, each employee is quite a bit of a salary each month. Alright, they're working. I guess one guy's having a sick day or a day off or whatever. Because he didn't come in. I don't know if we'll do one iteration of the design document or two, maybe. Two would be enough. It's a bit filthy here. Can we get a cleaner in again? Never cool cleaning. I wonder if he'll come in now before the next day. And then later you have to like call IT support because your computers will get, you know, they just get shittier over time. Who's this? And what is that link there? That seems like a random bot account. Unless you want to explain to me what that is, I'm just going to assume you're a bot and block you, okay? Thank you very much. By the way, people, don't click on that link, it's probably bullshit. There's been a lot of crap going around lately. Could be a link to one of those bot profiles that try and steal your information. So I don't even want to click on it. Nah, screw it. It's just going. Hey, Yakman! How you going? Welcome. Give me a second while I block what is presumably just an arsehole bot who just pushed a totally random link here. Man. Yeah, done. If anyone wants to post a link, that's fine, but just talk first, you know? Don't just come in here and just post a link. Yeah. That's pretty much, that's about all I ask. It's not a very harsh set of requirements. But, yeah, as we know, there's been quite a bit of botting going on lately on Twitch, and hate raids, and information stealing and stuff like that, password stealing. Yeah, what are you up to, Yakman? A few minutes, are you going shopping? Getting food and beer? They shuck on some noita for now, eh? Any fun shopping plans? Yeah. We'll save this game, could come back to it later or just some other time. It's interesting. Well, it depends what you're into, but it can be interesting. Save game as Warsoft. Twitch 1. Noita will be good fun. You'll get to see me get my ass kicked a bit. It's very different than that game we just played, though. So let's change the name of the stream, or the category of the stream. Hang on. Just category can be Noita, which I think is Finnish for witch. And I play like a witchy, wizardy person that tries to not die and tries to turn the whole world into gold, pretty much. Right, let's get her ready. I haven't played this in a while, so I might be a bit rusty at first. New game. Okay. All new game, I guess. Alright. What did I do? Sorry, I just lost my chat for a second. Yeah, I don't know if anyone's seen this game or hasn't seen this game, but it's pretty much a procedurally generated sort of a platforming game. But it's, I start with, like, one spell. I might have to turn the sound down. And I just had to kind of... There'll be a lot of enemies trying to kill me. I have to try and get my way down to the bottom and kill the boss and effectively turn the world to gold. Well, that's one ending, anyway. Music volume, sound effect volume. It's apparently already low, but sounded loud to me. I'm guessing it was a bit loud at your end. Let me just change it from here. Or out. You can't see what I'm doing. Volume mixer. How's the sound level? That's not overpowering my voice. So in this game, pretty much every little pixel is simulated in terms of it can be destroyed or it can be interacted with. Like, I've already knocked down some oil lamps and started a fire. I can kick some things. I've got quite a mighty kick on me, actually. Wood obviously just burns. Could be a little low now. Okay. It might just be mine then. I'll just have to turn my headphones off. Or down, yeah. That was too loud of mine. Is that better? The music is quite subtle in this. Like, it's kind of it reacts to what's going on, but it's kind of backgroundy. But I mainly just don't want that sound effect to be loud and annoying because it's going to be repetitive. I'll just pause my video preview for now because it seems to work. So yeah, if I start with a wand and it's got one spell on it, which is I got two wands with it. This one has an energy sphere, which is just a basic damaging spell. But you can get all sorts of spells that we'll just kind of see as we get them, because it's quite random what we'll find. And we get money from killing enemies, which we need to buy things between each level. And between levels, we can also get healed. If we even make it that far. And we got cool explosive boxes and other things. Enemies that pounce on you, like this guy. Oh, that's a wand there, that shiny stuff. Need some enemies. I want that gold before it disappears, but no. Whoa! Oh yeah, I can't hover through, but... Oh! Forgot to tackle you. Whoa. Damn it. There's gold that I want. I'm on fire. Oh yeah, you start with a random liquid now. You used to start with water, but now you start with a random liquid, so you can't even always put the fire out, so... I might be kinda dead already. What's this game called? Noita. N-O-I-T-A. It should say in the category as well. The game category. somewhere on the page. You're on the app though, aren't you? I'm probably just going to die quite quickly and call this my warm-up run. But yeah. I do have a secondary spell as well, which is... I can't get through there. I'll use it in a second. But what is that liquid? I've got... Berserkium. Okay. That makes me get higher damage, I think, for a temporary amount of time. And also makes explosions bigger, which can be very dangerous. Oh yeah, there was a wand up there I didn't even get, because I was getting set on fire. So, yeah, each one has different stats, like in terms of how fast it can shoot, how long it takes to recharge, max mana on it, because each spell takes up a bit of mana. This one here has got four spells on it, or light, it's not a damaging spell, and three fireballs. So we can hold four wands at a time, so that's fine. And you can also make your own wands out of what, you know, you put the spells on yourself. But we'll do that a bit later. You tried the game Carry On. No, that looks quite interesting. Apparently it's quite short. But that means I could maybe even pass it in one stream, so it's not a bad thing. Yeah, now I've got a fire spell, which can actually burn. Whoa. Oh, and it splits into two, apparently. Well, sometimes it splits into two. Ow. Hard to aim. You quite often, when you pick up a wand, it won't be in the best state. You might have to edit it a bit first. Nice. Alright, what else can we find, then? Guys that throw dynamite have quite a bit of health, relatively. Not that much, really. You try it now, just don't cross the streams. Yeah, exactly. Not when anyone's watching, anyway. Yay, water. I kind of need to get some water, because, you know, fire, getting caught on fire is not good. I could empty out my flask here and just, get water instead. Oh, it doesn't matter if I touch this. There we go, we'll just leak that over the edge a bit. Take it off. Come on. And dip some water. There we go. Berserkium is handy, but water is freaking useful. Mainly just for saving your ass when you're on fire, but still. Even if that's all it does, that's fine. Come here, you little runt. These are like oil lamps, which can burn things. Right, you're off then. Hopefully I'll catch the end of your stream. Yeah, I'll be on for a little while. Catch you in a bit, or a bit later. What's that? Acceleration potion. Okay, that's nice. It makes me speedier, I think. Alright, these guys can sometimes blow themselves up if you're lucky. Whoa! Oh, money, money, money. You want a good few $100 or gold or whatever for... Whoa, per area, at least. Or more as you keep going further on. Oh, yeah, enemies like that you can kill with water, if they're real burny looking. Ah, there's a wand in there. This is metal, so I can't break through that easily. What's that? Something hurt itself? Alright, more money. What's this? Broken wand. They can be a bit weird. But you can like drop them in places and they cast spells. Oh yeah, my scroll doesn't work. How do I throw this? Like that. Okay. Kinda works. I can like coat myself in a bit of water, meaning that the fire, like I won't get caught on fire, which is handy. For a little while anyway. Oh, he's on my team. That's why I can't shoot him. Okay. I apparently charmed him. There's a few different ways you can charm enemies. Robes are incredibly flammable. Yeah, they are. It turns out. Oh, yes, Acceleratorium does kind of what it sounds like. It makes me faster. Whee! Like that. Just for a little while. Oh, I want that thing. Burn.
Ah!
What a... Wand. Damn it. Can I explode things? That hopefully will explode. Ah, don't know if it made much of a dent in the wall though. A little bit. Kinda do want to get through there. It's not really digging much, is it? Yeah, you can make a wand that specializes in just like digging, and that can actually be real handy as well. So this is quite a new game. It's actually fully released now, because it was in early access for a while, and it seems to be properly like finished now, from what I hear. And it didn't even take too long, just a year or two. If that, you know. Whoa! What the fuck was that? Oh! What the fuck caused that? I can view a replay. Because you can even save replays of your deaths if you have like a real epic death in this game. Or even if you don't die, you can do it. Loving the graphics. Yeah, it's real cool, like real cool style. And we'll try that again. I very likely won't even get past this first area on my first couple of tries. Stats, save death replay. So that might have been there are some humanoid like wizard creatures that pretty much if they find a wand they can use it. So I think that's what I might have encountered as someone with a wand, meaning they could have had any spell. You never know, you know. Never know what they might have found. Because like I'll start again, and the first area will look more or less the same, but it's all kind of like the placement of everything's like randomized, and the map design's all randomized. But the theme of each level is still the same. It'll still be the same kind of terrain. Let's surf down on this. Okay. So this is what I'm starting with now is what the game, when the game first came out, is. It started with this wand and a bomb wand, which is this one, and water, which is the water and the jar and the flask. So that's quite good because I'm familiar with this. And this weapon's okay. It's like pretty fast, pretty accurate. Not high damaging, but. Oh, what's that oil? So I've got to be careful with oil on me because I'm slippery and more flammable. Yeah. Whoops. But I can wash it off a bit. Like. Or it just wears off over time, but I just have to be careful. Right, now we just want to be searching for money and good wands, or any wands at first. Yeah, the good thing about this wand is it doesn't actually run out of mana, it recharges faster than it drains mana. So I can keep firing at that rate, at that speed, you know, without any issue. Oh, these guys suck, but I can kill them with water. That's their one big weakness. Come on. Nice. He would have, like, launched fireballs at my face, and, you know. But water, I told you it's useful. That's made of wood if I wanted to burn through it. Right. So I won't fully explore each area, but you just kind of, I don't know, get enough money and make sure you don't die and try and not be too risky and then move to the next area. Because I'll get healed between the areas. And I'll get a new spell, or a new skill. Oh, we'll see. Oh yeah, they literally drop some acid-y stuff, which is not great. Not great to touch. Oh, I can get more water. Nice. Oh yeah, I better not drown. You can even drown in like smoke like this, like you run out of oxygen. If it's too smoky or steamy. Yeah. I can kick this thing up here. Oi. That's gunpowder, I believe. Oh yeah, it tells you what everything is when you mouse over it. Alright, there's a wand. Oh, nice, got him. I'll get some water on me so I can pick up that gold. And the wand is... Okay, it's got a black hole spell, which is a digging kind of a spell. Digs through the ground. Which is kind of what I'll use my bomb for as well. But the bomb actually damages things. But this is a good find. Not a bad find. Obviously, I want to get some better weapons. Or attack spells. But for now. Black hole will probably actually come in handy to find other spells. Like if they're stuck between some land. Because black hole can burn through anything, dig through anything, I think. Seemingly. So we haven't lost any... Well, we've lost one health so far. That's fine, though. Check out all these dark areas. Find more stuff. Oh, these little spider things. Well, there's a couple of them. They can be quite sneaky sometimes. Just pounce on you when you can barely notice them. But that's a whole bunch of blood, of course. Yeah, and there's a lot of different enemy types in this game. Like, even this first area probably has like 8 or 10 different enemy types. But you don't always encounter some of them. Oi, come here. Come here. Right, $200. We want a bit more than that. Okay, we've got a hole to the surface. That's rare. Unusually, but we don't need to go anywhere on the surface yet. That's something you can do later. You're mainly going downwards for most of the time, but there's a few like hard to get to, like secret endings of the game, and they involve going to different areas and different directions. And you can even enter parallel worlds and stuff like that, which is another complicated thing I've never tried, because it can take a long time. A lot of time and skill. Is that going to burn? That might burn through that. Ah, cheap wine. But yeah, for a 2D game, it is real nice graphics, as I believe I'd say. Like, at first glance, it kind of looks kind of old school, but like a lot of what's going on is relatively, you know, you wouldn't be able to do it with an old computer. But I think my brother's laptop even doesn't play this game too well, like he has to lower the graphics down a bit, or the resolution. Money, money, money. Oh, shotgun guys. Gotta watch out for them. Oh, can I just drop a bomb down there? Oh, I went too far down. Whoa! Oh, they're bombing me. Damn it, I was stuck on something. Ah, he blew himself up! Awesome. Yeah, they do that a bit, the TNT guys. He's covered in blood. For whatever reason. Hey. Nice. Get some water, and you can get mixed substances in a jar. So I might have got like a bit of blood in my flask, but that's fine. No maps to uncover. I'd be so lost. No, that's why. Luckily, for most of the main game, you're just going downwards. Like, I'll explore this area here, like left and right, and then I'll go downwards. But if you're on the surface, you can go quite far to the left and right. But underground, it's limited size. You don't really get a map. People have made maps of the game, but of course it's like different each time, so a map's only kind of a suggestion, you know, like it's an approximation of what the game's like. And then you can play on hard mode, where it randomizes even the levels that you go to, like, you might not even start in this area. You know. Hey. Oh, nice. Did he blow himself up? Oh, no. Alright. Oh, cool. The S is flammable. Oh, this guy, damn it. Piss off. Go away, go away. It's another one of those flamey guys that I can hopefully kill with water. Where is he? Can I get more water? Oh, he's still there. Really don't want to get near them. See, there's a portal down to the next area, so I'm already at the bottom of this level. I'll just die. I need to get more water, but still. Ah! Oh, here's a spell. Individual spell. Pollen. That's new. Or new for me. Right, I'm going to have to find more water, really. I think there's a pool just back here, wasn't there? Yeah. It's over there. So I got a bit of money now. I could go to the exit, but I still wouldn't mind a bit more money. Just because you never know what kind of things are going to be sold, because you can buy things between levels. You want a bit of spare money just in case. Ooh. Hey. Holy Mountain. Even though that's technically just below me, but oh well. We'll go to one exit sometime soon. There's a few, all these exits go to the same place. Money. 365. Okay. Ah, see this track here is like, I think there's like, you get big worms that make these paths, I think, and they can be dangerous. Well, that's a small one, relatively, like, even though it looks quite thick, compared to my guy. There are some huge worms that can really mess up your day. Pool of blood there for some reason. It might have started there, or something might have happened, I don't know. This guy's covered in blood, he might have been killing or eating things, I don't know. Toxic sludge. So I got nearly $400. Oh, that's right, you can't kick. You can't even kick enemies, but it'll be quite precise, like you have to be right on them or right in front of them, you know. And that can be dangerous. Or you can kick things into enemies, and that can be quite an effective way to kill things. Like get a physics kill, which is quite powerful. I can go east to get like over that lake. You can get like some handy item. I can't remember what it is, but they've added like two bosses over there now that are randomized and that they're dangerous. It used to be like almost a risk-free way to get some stuff, whatever it was. Can't remember now, but now it's definitely not risk-free. Alright, I've explored most of this area. There's, I haven't even got $400 though, so there's probably some more enemies to kill if I wanted to. Come on, money. I want a bit more money. You can even see gold in the landscape. You can, you know, if you find a way, you can bomb that out or dig it out. Because all my spells with limited ammo recharge. So if I'm about to exit, I might as well use my bombs and my, what was it, black hole. And get some stuff from the land, you know. Oh yeah, so I picked up a tablet before, which they have a bit of lore on the game, if you read them. Or you can just throw them at things, and they're quite good because they're like hefty, or hefty enough. Oh, this sludge stuff, you can actually mix a bit of water in with it, and water dilutes it really well, like that, see? Mix it up with a wand. And it's quite effective. It eats it up. So that's nice. There's a lot of different chemical reactions like that. And just yet another way that water is really useful. What's up here? Uh-huh. Come here. Come here. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Ah, he got shot, I think. He took the bullet for me. Nice. Turn the tablet back on, because I turned the screen off. That's fine. Yeah, you got to watch out for those shotgun guys. They can do a bit of damage. Whoa. There's a wand. That's probably what I needed. Money. Ah, shit, it's that guy again. Oh, can I kill him this time? Not him, but fireball guy. Oh, there's all this accelatorium that's diluting the water that I'm pouring, damn it. Whoa. Okay, I might just have to be careful and not go down there. What was that? Oh, you've got a wand here with some spell, bubble spark, and quite fast recharge. What's that like? It's a bit spready, but that could be okay. Yeah. Okay, we've got Fluxium Potion now. I can't recall what that does exactly. But hang on, we'll have a look in a second. I don't know if they have a description, you just have to like figure out what each thing does. Oh yeah, this one confuses you or the enemies. So if it touches you, it makes your controls get messed up. Would a bomb kill fire guy? I know he's got quite a good resistance to fire, but explosion damage and fire damage are two different things, so it might work. If I can get one down there. I just know water's the most effective thing if it reaches. Oh, okay, so I can go to an area to my left, but that's going to increase in difficulty quite a lot and might not be worth it. But I would also find better stuff, better loot. Yeah, I don't know if I want to mess with that fire guy. I mean, I'd get a bit of money off him, but it's, I don't know if it's worth the risk. Might just see what else is around, because I've lost half my health already. Quite a lot of these TNT guys, so that's fine, they're pretty dumb. Give me money. Was he down there? He might have moved or died. Oh, there might have been enough water there to kill him. Whoa. He dropped some more enemies. Ah! Whoa, careful. Yes, you have to like try and figure out and remember which liquids are flammable and which ones aren't. Because that can become an issue. Oh, that's melting through. Oh, it's melting through the temple, that's not good. If you destroy too much of the temple, even if you don't do it yourself, like, you had to face, like, an angry god, pretty much, who's not... Like, they're possible to kill, but that early in the game, they're quite hard. Nice. Hopefully that's not melting through too much of it. It'll tell me if the gods are angered, but... The gods called... Well, people in there have called him Steve, because all the enemies in this have, like, their finish name. And like, so a lot of them have like real long names that I'll never remember, but the god is pretty much called Stivari, so people just call him Steve. Because why not? It's easier to remember. Boom. What's over here? We'll head to another area soon, just to see a bit of variety, because each area changes. Well, the second area is not too different, but after that, the areas are quite drastically different each time. What? A lot, so I get some real snowy areas and icy areas. Yeah, let's go. Alright. Boom. So every temple is pretty much the same structure. You always get two pools of water. You can always get a water refill. Always get a health refill. Always get an ammo refill. I probably should have used up some ammo, but who cares. And you'll always get a shop. In this case, it's a wand shop. And you'll always get a choice of three skills. And you also get the chance to edit your wands. Like, now I can take spells off and make my own wands however I want. Which I might do a bit. Like, I can take these off. Oh yeah, I got this pollen sperm. What's that do? A small floating projectile that homes towards enemy creatures. That could be interesting. Could even work on this wand. The bad thing about the bottom wand is it's got quite high spread, 8 degrees. Meaning, like, if I try and shoot forward, it could go up or down by 8 degrees. And so, I mean, it's just not as accurate as you might want it to be. Starting ones are always pretty average, but this bomb wand, I can actually put my spark bolt that I started with, I can put that on the bomb wand and go like this. Now it makes it quite a fast firing one. So, but yeah, but that does shoot through a bit of mana that recharges, but you know, that's fine. So I'll usually go to pick one of these first. So what do we got? Levitation Trail. When levitating, you leave a trail of magical spark that harms passing creatures. This is new to me, this one. I guess that could be a good... So, like, if I hover like this, that means I leave a trail that hurts enemies. Projectile duplication. Your projectile spells have a chance to duplicate, but you're more vulnerable to projectile damage. Ooh. Or, I think I'll get this one, permanent shield. It's literally just a blue shield, which if it gets shot, it'll temporarily disappear, and then I can get hit, but then it'll, like, charge back up again. But it pretty much just protects me from a lot of damage. It's pretty good. Now, wands. So I could pick a wand based on the spells or the wand, or both. You know, depending on the stats. Like, that's a shotgun spell, that triple green one. That's quite good. Early on, anyway. So I'm not sure what I should be looking for. That first one's good. It's a spark bolt, which is my normal attack, but with a trigger, meaning it'll shoot a spark bolt, and then that can trigger another spell of your choice, or whatever's next in the chain. And because that's how you start making quite interesting wands. And this has got double spell, meaning it'll cast the first two spells at the same time. Oh yeah, and if it says shuffle, yes, that means the order is random. Like, you know, it won't necessarily go 1, 2, 3, 4, like, in the right order. It could go any order. But this one has no shuffle, so that's quite good. So what do I want? And I can only carry 4 wands, so I'll probably have to drop one of mine. Oh yeah, so I've got this now. I don't know how good this will be. This homes in on enemies. I don't know how far it'll go though. Could be good though. So I can maybe get rid of my first wand because it's just got pretty basic stats. Choose one of these to get maybe. What's that spell? Chain Bolt. Fires a mysterious bolt that jumps from enemy to enemy. Ah. Oh, a lot of mana. It's like 80 mana a shot as opposed to like 5 or 10 from some other things. Or I could get this, what's it called? Triplicate Bolt, which is pretty much like a shotgun blast. Yeah, it's pretty good damage though. And you can put Fire Trail, which you can make it so a projectile has fire, leaves a trail of fire behind it. Be good to get some wand without shuffle though. What is the mana on that? Okay, so that's got 240 mana, so even though it's 80 mana, it's got 240 max, and the charge speed is pretty good, 50, I think that's like per second. And what's that light? So I might get this wand just because it's not a bad wand. Spread is minus 2 degrees, meaning it can actually lower spread if other things add it. Hey, Elder than Joel, look who's on, when you can drop in. How's it going? Welcome by. A few people hanging out there now. Or I can get this thing here. What is this bolt? Return. After a period of time, you'll be returned to where you cast the spell. Eh. I don't know if that's going to help me much. I might get this one then. So this apparently like links between enemies. I think there's a training dummy that you can use as well to see how much damage things do. Is it this? 25 damage, 3 damage. Is it going to home in it? 5 damage. I don't know if it homes at that speed all the time, or... I guess so. But some enemies could kind of outrun that if they try, but... Audio is having an issue here. Is it? Just for you? What's going on? What's wrong with the audio? So I guess I'll keep this array of... things, black hole, we'll put that at number 1, that at number 2, that at number 3, black hole number 4, okay, try that out for now. No issues on your end, sweet. Yeah, I'm sure someone would have not mentioned if it was happening to everyone. Right, so I don't think I need to mix these wands up, unless I want to put, like bubble spark instead of this. Well, that is fast, but it runs out of mana real fast. So I don't think I want it to do that. I don't even need light on that spell, really. It's probably just taking up extra mana. Yeah, that could be good. That maybe could be good, I don't know. Could do it like that, just to give it a bit more variety of, you know. I might as well, I've got the spare mana. Reloaded again, yeah fine, that fair enough. Reloading fixes most problems on Twitch, well a lot of them. You were getting video fine, the audio is about half. I've had it do that sometimes, or it can be delayed sometimes. Well. So yeah, welcome in then, how's it going? Let's go to the next area. With our fancy new shield and fancy new spells. Well, they're not that fancy, but the shield's pretty good. Oh yeah, and it gets sealed off every time you exit one of these. But at least the god doesn't get pissed off for that. I guess he probably caused that damage himself. Right, next area. We're in the coal mines, or the coal pits. Whoa. I maybe could have killed him by, like, dropping rocks on him, but... Whoa, okay. See, this brick stuff's real tough. Like, not much will destroy that brick stuff. Although my black hole might do. So this area is kind of similar, but there's obviously a lot more coal, for one thing. So it's like a coal mine. There's a little of that gold in there if I wanted to dig through and get it. I might even do that at some point. But I can come back for that. So, yeah, we've still got $426. It's not bad, considering I bought a wand. But we want to get more, maybe. Yeah, a lot of this terrain is actually quite soft. It's fairly easy to dig through. Like, this spell won't dig through it, but some others will. Oh, yeah, there's a wand down there. Might want to get this guy first, though. Whoa. Blow yourself up. Go on. Did he do it? No. Ow! I already lost a quarter of my health there. Right, what's this wand? Okay, quite big. You can get some that had like heaps of slots. Like this is not even a very big one, really. So that's got heaps of spark bolts with triggers. Usually you don't need heaps of them. The wand itself, though, is quite good. But I'd have to drop one of these to be able to pick it up. That's the problem. Not that these are incredible. Like, I could drop that spell I was just using, it's not too great. Hey, but this wand isn't incredible either, it's just pretty average. I think I'll leave that. Alright. Whoa, new enemies. Oh, this one spits out little enemies. Yeah. Ah, that worked. And they have a slime blood, which pretty much slows you down. But it's also flame retardant, I think that's the word. Like, when you're covered in this stuff, it's like water. You won't get caught on fire. So that's nice. But it does slow you down, which is not as nice. It's sticky. Alright. Whoa. That's a toxic sludgy barrel. Critical hit. So yeah, I can't edit my spells again now that I'm back in a normal level. But you can get a perk that lets you edit spells anywhere, which is very handy. Ooh. What are they? They seem new. Well, this might be a side area. Whoa. Yeah, fungal cabins. So I could go in here if I want to be a bit risky, yeah, but I don't really have to be spells. So I think I'll leave that for now. Because of course, with the risk is reward. Usually, maybe, sometimes, depends. And luckily there's no fall damage, so... Fall from any height, really. Nice. Hey, die. Whoa. He's got a wand. Oh no, he's... Or he might just have his own magic spell, I don't know. Home in. This could work. Maybe homing is helpful. It's just slow. Oh, another one. Damn. Okay, I can just... That kind of homes in as well. That's nice. Can I get that money, though? Yes. And there's a wand, if I can get there. So I'm technically in the fungal cabin, so this can... Like, there's harder enemies. So I could try and get up there, but it's a little bit of a risk. Oh, that guy can use wands, I think. But does he have any? I guess the shield's already saving my ass a bit, I don't know. Nice. Homing's handy for these guys, because they're so hard to hit usually. They're tiny and fast. Well, there's a lot of them. Out. there's half my health gone already, just because I'm hanging around in the fungal caverns. Hey, what the fuck? Did he just fall down and get hit by my homing things? No! I'm getting a bit of good money. Oh, I don't know if I want to risk getting that wand. I might just try and get normal wands over here. I already got a bit of money, so that's nice. Okay, these guys have lava for blood. And they have slime for blood. I quite like this attack. It's like a pretty fast homing. As opposed to my slow cotton spores, whatever they are. Pollen spores, not cotton. Hey. Whoa. Right, what do we got? Don't want to get that stuff on me, really. Toxic sludge. Bad. Okay. What do we got? Not much around here. Boot. Not much down there. Whoops. Whoa, sprayed a bit. Gunpowder in there. Yeah, they dropped lava. So you can make obsidian out of lava by spraying water on it. And that's how you cross a big pit of lava, is by spraying water on it. Whoa, what the fuck? Why did he not do anything? Money, money, money. So we're down at the bottom of this area already. Might as well do a bit more farming for gold, you know. Oh. Sludge. I mean, I've probably got an alright amount of money. Because my health's getting a bit low. I don't want to be too risky and explore too much. Right, what have we got though? It might just be something else, maybe another wand I can find. Okay. Oh yeah, I can use the black hole on all this gold here. Which one's black hole? Number 4. Like this. Oh, it eats all the gold up, damn it. That's where bombs can be handy, because bombs would have just blown it out of the ground, but I think I just literally burnt through the gold. Oh well, screw it. We'll just head towards the exit. What's over here? You can, like, dig in this direction and see what's over there. Nope. You can modify that spell to make it faster, so it'll go through heaps more land than that, but that only really covered a small area. There's some gold on the surface, so I can just literally just touch to pick up. But yeah, I don't really have any basic explosives on me. Or not set up and ready to use. Some slimy stuff. Nice. Get the gold before it disappears. It hangs around for like 10 seconds almost. Damn little guys throwing potions. I think of those guys that throw those potions, which they're damaging potions, but if you time it really well, you can actually catch the potion. And the flask that he used holds twice, I think it's twice as much as other flasks, which isn't the biggest deal of all time, but it can still be handy. Okay, let's just go back to the holy mountain. Jump. So the teleporter is just taking me from, like, slightly above me to down here. It's not going far. Right, we've got some water, but we're good for water. We'll get recharges. So now we can buy individual spells, as opposed to just a wand. So this can be a bit more versatile. they're all quite random weird ones. Explosion of Spirits, Explosion of Thunder, Energy Shield Sector, so it makes like the spell give, or the, when I hold the wand out, it'll have like a kind of a shield like this. Glittering Field, Rock, like summons a rock that throws forward. Rock Spirit, add mana, that can be good. I'll grab that just for like, even later, I don't even need it now, or maybe I could use it. Actually, I could put that on my spell that's doing a lot of zappiness, whatever you call it. I might add a bit more mana to this thing. Yes, now I can do that like a lot more if I need to. Because that's good damage, and it's homing. That's cool. I guess I'll keep this other homing wand, but it's kind of been replaced by this one now. So, if anything, I'll replace this second wand here at some point. Alright, now let's see what power perk we can get. High mana, low capacity, one off. What? Your currently held wand loses half its capacity but gains more mana. I don't think I'll get that. Homing shots is good. Your spells home towards enemies very slightly. It's only a slight effect, but still. Never skip leg day. Your kicks deal extra damage and knockback. I never rely on my kicks and stuff, so I might just get this homing thing, even if it's just a slight effect. You can't complain about homing. Or I could have paid 200 to have them switch with other choices, but that's fine. Let's grab some wine quickly. But that 200 price doubles each time you use it. So it's 200 is cheap at first, you know. Then it becomes 400, 800, 1600, lots more. And yeah, but you do end up with thousands of money. I guess they're dollars, I don't know. Right, here we should enter a quite different biome. Terrain, like different terrain. Whee! Snowy depths with all new enemies and stuff. Oh, and some old enemies like that. Beep! Squeak! This thing just one-shot so many enemies. There's this ice like this that you can actually crack and make it fall down and then hurt enemies. And potentially hurt myself, I think. Ooh. Oh yeah, that freezing gas stuff is quite damaging. Or it can be. Oh, this spell's handy as. Especially just because it's so much damage right off the bat. Oh yes, I'm facing a lot more of these humanoid enemies. Like I think they're called Heishi, which... Not Heishi as in male-female, like Heishi as in... I don't know, it's a Finnish word, but... H-I-S-H-I-I or something. Heishi. And there's quite... Yeah, there's quite a few of them in the game. Never seen this before. Whoa! What the fuck? That's totally new. What the fuck? This better not kill me, because I've already got this far already. But I might leave that alone. Damn it, why did I kick a random... Oh, there's snipers now. Fuck, I'm on 42 health already. He's new as well, damn it. Well, what's going to kill me now? Alright, at least I can kill them in two hits. And kill them in one hit. Oi. Wait, why are you going up there? Oh, he's trying to home through the ground. That's not always the best thing then. Hey, I went through two of them, nice. I suppose it does go from enemy to enemy. Yeah, there's two wands around here, what are they? That one has a whole bunch of prickly spore pods. Summons a spore pod, it attaches to a surface and then glows, then grows and explodes. Max mana is crap, it's only 100 and something, but the mana recharge speed is awesome, but it doesn't really matter when the max mana is so low, I guess. What kind of wine you got? It's called Chasseur, which is probably meant to sound fancy, but it's just like cheap cardboard box wine. Because, I don't know, I like red wine and I don't really care, like, the difference between cheap and expensive red wine. Hey. Whoops. Why is this not working? Hang on. Did I run out of mana for a spell? What's wrong with it? It's like I couldn't shoot for a bit there. Oh yeah, how do I get in there? Ooh, I gotta watch out for that. So that thing's surging off electricity, meaning anything liquid or metal, or certain liquids and all metals, will, yeah, you can see there, it's like dangerous. You got to be real careful of that. If there's some enemies are electric themselves, so if they just like touch or attack you when you're in water, you're just dead pretty much. Don't feel bad about refined. My favourite is lightly carbonated. Yeah, I've never had a problem with cheaper wines really, but considering how much price difference there is in between cheap and apparently good wine, there's a lot of price difference. So yeah. Oh, it's that guy again. No, I already pissed him off. I gotta watch out for all this gassy stuff. It's, I'm trying to remember what it is in the game. I can't remember. It's just not. It just hurts. It's not good. Propane maybe, because I think there's like you can get little canisters of it, and you can like use them to attack enemies, or they can hurt you as well. Nice. Whoa! Bit of a landfall. Landslide. What's that? Something died here. What is that? Oh, another broken wand. Nah, don't really need that. Oh, treasure chest. Go, 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 go. Oh, a lot of money. Cool. Oh, watch out. I nearly just shot an explosive that was right beside me. 26 health. I should probably just maybe go to the exit. Since I already got hurt a lot. Older than Joel's lurking. Oh, good. Have a good one. Cheers for popping by. Ooh. Whoa. Damn snipers. And they're good range. Ow. Oh, I think I was getting hurt by, what do you call it? The toxic sludge. Screw it, let's go to the next level. Don't feel bad about cheap. Oh, yeah, I read that. Yeah. Cheap wine's good. Or cheap red wine. Not really into white wine anymore. Mainly because I don't know, I don't really like sweet, real sweet wines. So now we've got some wands here that cost a bit, but I can afford any one of them. Nothing outrageous on a quick look. So let's look at some spells. I mean, perks. Faster projectiles, your spells fly faster than before. Okay. Healthy exploration. Every time you visit a new area, you regain 60 health. Okay. So I guess that means when you go to the side areas and stuff, you regain some health, yep. And critical plus, you get more critical hits. I'm just going to grab that. Can't go wrong. Because some perks have, like, good sides and bad sides, but things like that are just good. Right, that's an okay wand. 7 capacity, no spread. I mean, no shuffle. 380 mana. 380 mana on that one as well. 370 mana and a variety of spells. 300 mana. Whoops, but it's a shuffle. And that's only got two slots. What is that there? Summon large explosive box. But I don't know if there's anything really worth it, or if I just save my money. Unless I just want to replace my crappy wand here, but... What's that? Plasma cutter. Plasma beam specialised at cutting materials. Well, that could be good. Might be worth getting just for that. So if I want to replace the wand, I can take the spells off it. I don't even know if I'll need them, but for now I'll take them off. And maybe see what this plasma cutter's like. So what else is on this wand? We've got Summon Spirit Rock. We can get rid of that for now. Fire Bomb. Slow Fiery Bolt. Small Teleport Bolt. That can be handy. Like you literally just make it so you teleport around. I don't think you can go through walls, though. Cursed Sphere. A projectile that brings bad luck to anyone it hits. I don't know how that works. Maybe they get more critical hits. And Firebolt will trigger. So this one is Mana Drain 40. It actually does damage as well as apparently cutting through materials. So I don't want to try it here, because like I said, I could piss off Steve the God. But we can try it at the next level. Which might be the Heishi base. which are going to be a lot of those little Heishi guys and some bigger Heishi guys, if it's the area I'm thinking of. So, oh yeah, and some bots, that's right, there's quite a few bots in this area. So if I remember, the difficulty picks up a bit here. Oh, nice. Oh, they drop oil. Oh yeah, these canisters are the ones that that shoot out, hang on, I'll talk in a second. That shoot out that stuff. That's not good. Okay, I can use this cutting tool, whatever it is, the plasma cutter. Shields. Damn snipers. Right, so these are like little shields that they put place around, but I guess you can kind of use them to your advantage as well. Damn it. Seems like sometimes this thing doesn't do anything. I don't know. See, like then I just clicked and it's... Oh, it's because it's trying to home down, I see. That's what it's doing, it just seems like it's doing nothing, but... It's home, trying to home through walls, but it can't. Well, not usually, I don't think. Whoa, that works. Whoa, who blew him up? Whoa! Screw that. What's the best way to kill him? Is he gonna come this way? Whoa, get away, get away. Nice. Monies! They drop a bit of money. Ooh, one of them dropped a wand. I'm guessing that guy had a wand that was so dangerous he literally killed himself with it. Oh yeah, because it drops with these rock spirits and they explode, I think. So that's nice. I don't think I want the wand. Well, the wand's okay stats. But I don't know if I want to lose any of these. I could lose the shuffle wand. Because black hole's replaceable. I mean, not the shuffle wand, I mean just the black hole wand. Because it doesn't have much mana. But this thing here has 540 mana and a 146 mana recharge per second. And capacity 11 could be good. Yeah, let's get it. And also that rock spell might be okay. I just had to make sure I don't kill myself with it. Could be good for like dropping down places like this. Whoa, do they home in or something? Maybe my slight homing even makes them home. I don't know. Is that explosive? I thought that was a big explosive crate. Brickwork. Oh! Oh, I got zapped there and stunned for a bit. Luckily that didn't damage me too much. Alright. There's some lockers and stuff. Hey, go away, go away, go away. Damn, this kills fast, that plasma wand thing. Plasma cutter. It has to recharge every couple of seconds. But even that homes. Like, the homing is apparently slight, but it's, I'd say that's fairly significant. And it can burn through this stuff. Meaning it can probably burn through most stuff. Well, nice. It's handy to be having a good way to get rid of these turrets, because they can be a bit of a pain in the ass usually. Okay, this wand is okay stats. Recoil. Whoa, shit. Ow. Whoa, watch out for all the shit. There'll be a lot going on in this level, this area. Damn it, the homing always goes for the closest thing. Which is not always great. But at least this thing just works. I mean, everything homes is homing a bit now, I guess, because of my skill. Shit, I'm on 21 life. You can even get some ways to heal, but they're not always direct or easy to use. Hey, go away, go away. I don't want to be shot. I've had enough being shot. My health's gone. Can I blow all this shit up? Whoa, nice. Well, as long as it doesn't hurt me. Oh shit. Oh, my shield is really actually helping. It's probably already saved my life, and like literally. Okay, that box is gonna blow. Let's just let it. All right. Nice. Get some money. Whoa, but be careful. So I'm still at the top, and I need to get down. But I've got 11 health, so I do very carefully get down. Okay. Oh. Come on, get down, get down. Fuck! Oh, I somehow plasma beam myself. Maybe that's how I was damaging myself earlier. Oh well, we'll try again. So I got down to the fourth area out of, I think when you, like just for a basic ending, I think there might be 8 or 9 areas, I don't know. Probably about 8 in the boss area, which is small. Okay. That was silly, I killed myself there, which is quite often the case. Oh, back to the start. So who knows what kind of spells we'll get this time. I was quite enjoying that one though. Hey, it's night time. Now I start with a blood potion. I don't know how that helps. You can throw potions as well as just pour them. You know, that might help sometimes. Depending on what it is, it can help. But that probably will break the flask. Hey, I didn't see any of them last game, and right away I got a maximum health up. So my health went to 125, but you still have to restore your health to get the extra 25. But still, that's great. Also, at the end of each level, you get an extra 10 life, which is better than nothing. But it's best to try and find a couple of those hearts each level if you can. Surprised I didn't see any last time, really. Oh well. Start all over again. There's quite a few enemies. Oh, there's one in there as well, is it? Oh, but it's guarded by one of these pricks. And it's probably inaccessible. Do I have bombs? Oh, no, I got magic missile. That can burn through things. But yeah, I'd have to continue with this bastard up here. And get through. Is that wood or? Oh, there's only wood there. I could probably get through that. But he's just going to be annoying. Could be worth it though. Oh, he's going to burn through it. I guess. Ah, shit, I want to get up higher so I can pour water on him. Come here. Come here. Come here. Oh, that's blood. I haven't even got water. I've got blood. Fuck. Do I have to just try and shoot him? Magic missile might not even hurt him much. Or at all. Oh, recharge. Oh, go away. I just get in there. Get the heart, get the heart. And get out. Don't come in here, don't come in here. Oh, you can come in here. You're alright. You're not alright, though. He's got a lot of health. And he bleeds mana. Oh, he bleeds lava. I think blood puts fire out. But I don't know if it puts this guy's flame fire out. Jeez, a lot of health. I've only actually lost 10 health, even though it looks like I'm on half, but that's because I've gained 50 health total. Maximum. Did he die? Okay. So that, yeah, if I can survive, then that's a good start. I'm getting the extra 50 extra health already. Oil, don't really want to get in that. I kind of want to replace my blood with water. Ah, here we go. Let's do it. It just looks like he's peeing blood. That's never a good sign. Empty, come on, there we go. Might not be enough water here, but... I can tip it downwards to get a bit more of an angle and get a bit more of it. Yeah. Alright. Water. Good start. 50 health. Even better start. Whoa, that's electric. Whoa. Flask of... Is that Phlomaxium? That confuses things. Okay, good help, maybe. Oil probably won't help. Oh, I need more mana to cast that. It's a real slow recharge. Ow. Okay, can I get that water? I mean that gold? Yep. Oh, we get it off me. Damn it. Yeah, usually the best way to get like, if you got some liquid on you, it hurts, like that toxic sludge. You can just, like, pour water above you. But if you know that the toxic sludge is on your feet, because you, like, walked in it, you can just shoot literally down at your feet, and that will, like, be the quickest way to get rid of it. The game is quite precise like that. But it took me a while to actually realise that was the case. Because the game doesn't really have any kind of tutorial. You just kind of learn by doing and dying. Or watching other people do it and die. Nice. What's up this way? Okay, cool. Get some water. Oh shit, that's electrified water, and I was just trying to collect it like it's nothing. Damn. I mean, it didn't get hurt, but... Yep. A wand with some, bulky things, bully things. Oh yeah, that's okay. Is that more damage than my spell? Yeah. I think. Wait. Damage 3, damage 5. Bit less accuracy. And range, but still. If we get up close. Another wand. Collapse mines. Don't know if I really want to go in there. Damn little frogs. What's this wand? Looks fancy. Puff of wind. Burst of air. That's right. 6 damage. Even though it's just called burst of air. It still damages. Yeah. What's this? Concentrated mana, nice. I think that makes your spell more effective for a short time, so you get more mana out of them. Yes. Oh yeah, but this won't break explosive boxes, it'll just blow them around. And same with these, I think. Oh no, apparently it will. And the air, I guess the air is very oxygen heavy because it's flammable. The air that I'm shooting at. Alright, this is okay for now. But by the time you get to the fifth area, so that's the area after the last one I got up to, you're in the jungle and you really want some, you need some decent like damage per second by that point. Yeah, because it's dangerous. Okay, think about hitting... Oh, I'm near an exit, so I should maybe get a little bit more money. And think about hitting the exit. Ooh, excuse me. Alright.
got?
Oh, he's got a wand. Oh, that's right. Like, all these humanoids can pick up wands. Yeah. So who knows what that wand does? Maybe nothing, maybe everything. Not much. It had Firebolt on it. Do I want to grab that? The wand itself is okay. Well, this one's got max mana 750, but the recharge time is 10. That's the one I'm using. I don't know if I really need this. I've got a damaging fire spell, so probably not. Ow, ow, ow. Alright, can we get some more water? Who the hell's firing at me? Oh, you picked it up. Damn it. Sometimes it's worth picking up wands just so the enemies don't have them. Everyone's trying to pick it up, everyone... I don't know, it's not too big a deal, but... It's... Oh, 9 health. Maybe I should exit. If I don't die first. Get to the exit. Whoa, don't be greedy, don't be greedy. No! Oh shit. Damn it, I got killed by a tiny little spider. Oh well, try that again without the getting burned and exploded so much, but... I was killed by a hummus, oh, that's what it's called. Is that how you pronounce it? It's like two dots above the A. Hummus. Again. Loading up. It seems to like reboot the whole game every time you restart, so I just gotta double check that it actually is still capturing. Alright. Boom. Can we surf down on this? I've got water, nice. Alright. Boom. Janka. Alright. Well, fire. Okay, that's okay. I had enough water on me. Okay, that's not too bad. So many ways to die in this. I mean, quite a lot of them involve getting exploded or burnt to death. But even if you do it to yourself. What's that? You call skews? Okay. Be dangerous. Ooh, health. I can get up there. Oh, what's this? Polymorphine. Oh, I don't want to polymorph. Polymorph bad. We need to morph to a different creature. Oh, how do I get in there? A bomb, maybe? I really do want to get in there. Nice. Health. Oh, one of these bastards. Oop, I polymorphed into the thing. No. What a... I can teleport. I can kill things by teleporting. I just want to turn back. I don't like this. Okay, that's better. Right, still haven't got much money though. Oh, that fiery guy's trying to chase me down. Oh, no, I can't really go that way. He can F off. There's a wand. Oh, no, I had to go back that way. Unless I blast through there somehow. I could do. I got bombs. No, not this way. No! Fucking piece of shit bomb. Oh, that could work. It'd be a good wand. Oh, I'm getting shot at. It's a bomb wand. Okay. Take that for more bombs, I guess. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that. Can I get this guy to walk into water? Because that'll kill him. Whoa. Yes. Nice, got his water. I mean, got his monies. Ooh. I could exit at any time now, but I've still got a bit of health. There's a wand pedestal, but someone's taken the wand. I think it's a wand thing. So you got to be wary. I mean, you always got to be wary in this game. Was he hunting one of the little enemies? Yeah, there are some enemies that don't like each other, so like the rats and stuff, or the Heshi will hunt them, because they just hate them. Which is funny. And handy sometimes. Ow. 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 What's this? Oh, it's got a circle of stillness, so you can like walk up to things and freeze them, which can actually be handy. Especially if the enemy's weak to ice. Treasure chest. I'll try and do a circle of stillness on this thing. And then you just shatter it a bit. Yeah. A wand was in that box. Lucky wands can't be blown up. Oh, that's got shotgun and triple spell. Simultaneously cast three spells, but of course it costs the mana of three spells. Got a shotgun, but it's got a, like every so often it casts all three of them, but with a lot more spread. Money out. Oh, what's that wand? Can I get it? Nice. Can I get to that one? Maybe I can't. I got enough money though. We can move on. Oh nice, this just digs through wood. Ow! Shit, my health. Do I want to get that item? I don't know if I really need it. Okay, I can't be taking any risks now. I just need to get to an exit without getting touched by all that damage. Come on, no monsters. Oh, health. Extra health. And I'll take a slight risk to get this, and we'll get out of here. Nice. So now I have... I'll get the health boost. What's my maximum health now? 160. Cool. And no water. Let's get some water. Ba-doo. nicely drunk. Well, I haven't drunk it yet. You can drink anything in this game, actually. I think if you push down when you're in it, or when you're at the bottom. But then you get full of liquids, which, depending on the liquids, can be good or bad. Right, we've got wands. One of them was a kind of digging one that could be good. And we've got perks, or I can replace the perks. But then I probably can't afford many wands. What's this? Revenge Explosion. You release a magical explosion upon taking damage, and gain 25% resistance against explosions. Luki minion. Summon a Luki minion to your help. You can also get Luki mutation, which gives you massive big spider legs. I don't know how it helps, it just looks interesting. Projectile Eater. Projectiles that fly into a small sector behind of you disappear. Okay, so you like don't get shot in the back. Well, with less chance of being shot in the back. Let's try that. So there's like a little back shield. Oh yeah, you can see it there. And I can move it even. That could be handy. Tiny bit of a shield. But I guess that one doesn't fade away. Nah, what do we want? Ooh, those spike blades can be dangerous. They can like bounce off walls and hit you. Or there's this thing here, which is a kind of a laser diggy wand thing. Let's maybe get that. Which wand do I need here? Pick triple spell off that. I'll get rid of this first wand. So now I got a fast basic spell. I've got this diggy wand, which is actually pathetic. It's slow. Could I put that on anything else? Might be better on... Yeah. Let's have a look. Better. You kind of want that one to be constantly casting, so it's like a laser saw kind of. But that's okay. We've got that. Which is good damage per second, with a bit of inaccuracy. Got up close, and we got this. Which should also be quite good damage per second still. Alright. Next, go to the coal mines. And we got a arse shield. Or you can quickly change it to any kind of direction, really. Oh, a wand. It's okay. It's got a high recharge time on that circle of stillness. Do I want that instead? There's a bit of wand. I'm stuck. Okay, I'm not stuck. Whoa. Tiny bit. Oh yeah, I got these fire bombs in there as well. 10 damage. Okay, short range. Well, medium range. But pretty good damage. And not the fastest projectiles, but still. And it can of course burn through wood and probably the soft coal stuff. Yeah, a lot of the stuff is relatively, it's kind of just like soft coal veins, yeah, so. Ha. Well, this is good too. Nice. Music gets a little bit more action-packed once the action picks up. Another wand. The wand itself is not incredible, and the recharge time is horrible. 2.97 seconds. And the spells are pretty bad. But it's got an always cast, which is a quite unique feature, really. Recharge. Gains grips projectile a frozen charge that will release on impact. so could be okay. Kind of just makes it so every shot that it has can do a bit more frozen damage. But apart from that, the wand itself is crap. Boom. What's this? Don't know. Is that wood? Oh, careful with that. Oh well. Right. Nice. You don't have to be overly accurate with this, it's got a good bit of spread on it, which can actually help. Whoa, that's a bit of a fall. Ow. Hey, treasure chest. Treasure chests can be mimics as well, of course, in a game like this. But they're usually something good. Except that's a bit dangerous. Though we could fill that with water fairly easily. Like that. And then get more water. Nice, please drown in that. I don't know. What a boot. Okay, a quick drink. Alright, let's go. The edge? Yeah, I believe it is. Do I want a bit more money? Wouldn't hurt. I've got quite a bit of health still. Let me just sit up straighter. Slime and blood and guts down here. What are they doing in there? Do I want to go over there? Or up there? Get some money. Maybe? Or did I melt it? Oh, I got a little bit of money. I think we'll exit. Getting warmer here. Barely need my warm dressing gown on that I've been streaming in all winter. Because it's not winter anymore. Alright. Health. Don't need that thing. We can always leave it for maybe coming back here. There are ways to get back here. Ooh, spells. Energy orb's good for digging, and that's cheap at the moment, so I'll probably grab one of them. I just want to double check what perks we have first. Oh, monies, what's this? Earn extra item in Holy Mountains. There will be an additional item in every Holy Mountain you haven't discovered yet. Oh, like in here? Fungal disease. When near danger, you sprout fungal growths. Raise fueled levitation. Killing an enemy makes you replenish some of your levitation power. Nah, we're going to replace them. Alright, what's this? Enemy radar. Okay. You can see nearby enemies. Yep. Summon Sadiku one off. You gain an artifact that allows you to call the Celestial Rage. Yeah. Or extra perk. It says from now on you will find an extra perk in every Holy Mountain. So I'll have a choice of four. That can be good. Obviously you want to get it early on, but I'm only in the second area, so yeah. I can't afford to pay more money for other perks. So it gives me no immediate effects. Add mana, that's good. I want to get add mana. Critical damage on oiled enemies. Get some add mana. Do any of my things need mana? I don't really chew through mana, apart from the top one, but I can't put, there's no extra slot there for the add mana. Triple spell, don't want that on anything. Not really, I guess we'll keep this arrangement for now. Snowy depths, what's going on down there? Something attacking that. Why is he getting hurt? Ow! Oh, there goes a quarter of my health already. Half my health, damn. Oh, three quarters of my health. Shit, usually those aren't too hard, but they kind of surprised me with a couple of them at a time. They came from both directions. The problem with 2D games is you get pinned by just two enemies coming from two directions because there's no other dimensions. Oh nice, froze one up. How can I get there? That's right, I do have this digging thing which is a bit slow but it does dig through most stuff. Whoa, that's got a lot of shit. Lightning bolt. You have to be careful, because when you're holding a wand out that has lightning spells on it, it counts as, I think it's electric, meaning if you're on water, like, it'll just zap you just for holding it. Even though that's pretty good, because, look at that. Explosive damage 500. Boom, and it's got a radius. I'll replace it for that, but yeah, I have to be careful when I'm holding it out. Because there's a bit of water around these areas. Get me out of here.